Broadcast rights for the Bubba the Love Sponge show have been granted to this station by the Bubba Radio Network and is intended solely for the enjoyment of our listening audience. Any rebroadcast, retransmission, or other use of this production without the express written consent of the Bubba Radio Network is prohibited.
This might hurt a bit.
Ready?
I'm already doing it.
Welcome to the Bubba the Love Sponge Show.
Relax. So I took a day off. I'll be back. It's not a big deal. I'm getting old. I'm past my prime. I need a couple days off here and there.
But beautiful segue, huh? How about that, huh? Mix. I don't know if you guys even know what a segue is.
It was the best ever. That was...
What's a segue? Let me.
The segue?
No, what is a segue?
Segue is you coming off of the best of with the music to you talking.
Well, it would be considered like transitioning.
Yes.
From one source to another, mixing them together, whether it be voice or, you know, two, pieces of music or whatever. It's called a segue.
Yes.
I knew Dan knew, so I wasn't going to ask Dan first.
Dan's mic's not on.
Oh, sorry, Danny. How are you, Dr. Dan Diaco?
Good morning.
Did you hear the best of, Dan, when I was trying to... Did you hear that break yesterday or no? Were you busy?
No, I didn't hear that part, no.
So, I was sticking up for my Muffy. Because originally I was like, well, he's only here 3 days a week. I'm going to give him a half a point below the full-timers. So we were kind of trying... Rhett, you know how... Rhett is kind of uncomfortable feeling how he's fitting in on the air.
I heard him talking about like he's not really understanding his place. Again, the blind melon bumblebee.
Hold on. I don't know if Mach is ever going to be available on the microphone. We're having a big caper right now. Rhett, are you there?
Hello. Yeah, he's back here supersetting the whole rack room.
All right, cool. So I'm just going to turn his mic. You know, his mic's on in case he wants to step in and give us an update. But here's what we got going on. Oh, by the way, Dan, for that break yesterday, I was rating the significance of, you know, from 0 to 10, how important you are to the pro, you know, each individual.
I thought it was like skill set.
Well, just, you know, skill set.
Cumulative
just,
score.
Yeah, like right. Just your overall, you know,
value
and worth.
Got it.
And I put Lummy and Anna at a 7. And then I initially put you to a 6.5 because I was thinking, well, because he's not here 2 days. But then I got to thinking, but his brilliance when he is here outshines so I put you to a 7.5.
Thank you, Muffy.
No problem.
That.
Right, what were you,
sweet.
Like a 4?
5.
Okay, 5. Okay, sorry.
Said I'll be a 7 soon, though.
You will be, buddy. You will be. You're going to be a 7 soon. Lummy's a 7.
Yay.
Anna's a 7.
Whoop, whoop.
So he just stiffens up when you give him a hug, you know? It's just, he's got that, like, autism sort of.
But
if he was in the Netherlands.
That's coming from a doctor, too.
If he was in the Netherlands, they'd have euthanized him by now.
Yeah, well.
Oh, yeah. Messed up.
So we, listen.
Actually, you gave Red a 6.5.
Oh, no
I
kidding.
Did?
Yeah, I got it written down, sorry.
Did you really?
Lummy.
I don't remember that.
You wrote it wrong?
No, Lummy's got it.
I wrote it 6.5. You gave Dr. Dan 7.5, Anna 7, Lummy 7. And Rhett 6.5.
I didn't rate Macho Man
or Brian.
Well, Brian, he's
in his own world.
Well, you can't rate.
He gave Brian a 6.5.
No, he didn't give it to him.
No, I mean Brian's a scratch, just because you know you don't. He's not here a lot, and when he you know just whatever. I mean, now if you want to score him on irritation, he's a 10. But if you want to score him on his ability to irritate, he's pretty damn good at it. I mean, if you look at it a couple different ways, right?
Yeah.
I mean, like, you know, he's irritating. He's a little snowflaking bitch most of the time, but he's a good snowflaking little bitch, isn't he?
Well, he's his own best fan.
So anyway, you know, I feel like Brian has an alternative, like a gimmick. Like, Dan, what you see is what you get. Like, you roll around this way all the way. Like, this is you.
A little amplified, but it is me.
Yeah,
and I'm not,
amplified.
And I don't have a secondary motive here. I'm here to just try to be, you know, insightful and funny at the same time.
Plus, it's
not an irritant.
Hold on, it's strictly a hobby for you because you don't get paid, but you just, I mean, like, you just.
We gotta
I
talk
think,
about that. I don't want a lot. I want like a dollar an hour.
Do you maybe give me?
Because I want to be paid, bitch.
You know, you give him a 7.5.
Show
five.
Me the money.
Hold on. Tommy. Yeah. You know, Dan is playing poker with the wrong dude because I will just say, Dan, I can't afford you. Sorry. Dan will be like, I'm still come around. So you're like, don't try to negotiate with me on the air, Dan.
I'll give you an envelope, dude. I just want a formality
just
of it.
Just give it $1 really, back.
I'll give it to you back.
Hold on now. So do you mean you just want to get a Bubba Radio Network check?
Exactly.
Oh, okay.
I need that specific income source.
Okay. So you can show.
Right, so that he can say he's a professional.
I'm paid,
so that you can say you're a pro air personality, aren't you?
Right. It'll be a college kid that, you know, I just don't want to, you know, they don't want to take that.
Be
that
a resume.
Official.
Well, it's a resume builder, too, because, right. Like, if anybody could ever question, well, you know, you didn't really technically get, well, I was an employee, bitch.
Yeah. Right. Uh-huh.
Yeah. Dan, I'll
boss.
Dan, I'll have you fill out a new hire paperwork packet.
I'll sign an NDA and all that stuff.
I got an NDA on you already. Did you know that? You
don't even get a W-2.
You don't even know. Like, I got back when the Diacos, you guys were doing your shows.
Back in the day, yeah.
Yeah,
we signed every month.
Well, I know. So I was Jesus. Going through. I was going through my 2257s, and I mean, like, I own you. I got every bit of content that you'd ever produce for me, or that you have produced. I own. Like,
yeah,
you know.
And God bless you.
Okay, so anyway,
do with it as you may.
What I'm saying is, yeah, Dan, I'll get you set up to pay you, like, you know, $1 a day.
Yeah, that's cool.
Or something like that, you know.
Doesn't
so like
do much.
$3 a week, so it'd be $12 total for 2 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
And then after taxes, you might get, like, what, $6?
Yeah, maybe. $6.50.
Just don't let Steven or Jay know, because they would think they would take it as an insult.
Yeah.
But I'm going to make sure to let them know, listen, guys, Dan's, you know, got some kind of ulterior motive. I don't know.
I'll be filling out those W-2s or
so. Anyway, Dan, yeah, I did put you as the most valuable person here. So
yeah, thank you.
But it's not a time to start negotiating your wages because you got voted on
7.5. I want $2 a
yeah,
day.
Exactly.
$1 a day. You don't value me.
Man, this is quickly escalating. Yeah. I mean, my God. Next thing you know, it's going to be $100 a week, and I can't afford that. So anyway, listen, here's the big caper we got going on right now, is that we're not even on the air.
Oh, no.
No.
Are we on the air?
Like, well, hold on. So
is this like a podcast?
Yeah, this is a podcast. But we're treating it as if it was a show. We're make-believing like we're live on the air. What we're going to do is we're going to record 25-minute blocks and then stop, take a 6-minute and 20-second break, none of which you guys can see any of this because we're not on the air. I mean, like, here's
like,
what happened.
How not on the air are we?
Well, yeah, I mean, are we terrestrially on the air?
No. Hold on. We're not even terrestrially on the
air.
Strike
the F?
So, no.
Or C?
No, because we have to edit
shut up.
It.
Hold on. Everybody shut up. I'm telling you what we're doing,
oh,
though.
Oh, sorry.
We're on the air, but we're live to tape right now. So what we're going to do is 25-minute segments. Like, what you're listening to on the air right now was done little. I'm going to really freak you guys out that are driving to work right now. What you're hearing on the radio right now was recorded at, like, 6:08 in the morning. So you're probably hearing it maybe, like, at 7 or something like that. Because what we're going to do, Anna, is we're going to do 25-minute blocks
'kay.
Of programming as if we were on the air, okay? Mm-hmm. And then we're going to stop and take a 6-minute and 20-second, you know, like we regularly would.
Yeah.
And then we're going to bump back in and do another 25 minutes.
Okay.
Which is because they have to put commercials in.
Uh-huh.
And then stop. And all we do is zip packet to them each segment. So we're going to do, you know, 7, and we missed the first one. But we have to do 7 25-minute segments. And what you're hearing on the air or watching on YouTube... No, I get. Let me.
No, we're nothing.
We won't have a. There won't be a visual show today at all.
This is being recorded though, and we'll be sure to upload it later.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
it's
the video we can record in house.
Stupid as I thought.
Yeah, we'll be up at like 10:30.
I almost got a half a point on that one, buddy.
Whoa.
I wasn't even thinking we were recording visually as well. I thought we were just straight audio.
Yeah, put your shirt back on.
Oh yeah. Ooh, my nips are getting out there. Woo! So. Anyway, it might blow your mind as well as if you're when you're watching this or listening to this, we actually are not live. We're recorded, but we have to act like we're live to be able to you know pull the gimmick off, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, but I don't know how much of a gimmick it is if I've already told everybody about the gimmick. I've already told everybody what we're doing.
It's more of a caper than a gimmick.
It's more of a work with us.
Yeah.
Realize that, you know, we needed to produce a show, but we didn't have any internet to coming to the building today, which shows us a couple things. One, how just absolutely reliant we are on our internet connection. And we probably should be responsible and get like, we have Frontier. We probably should get like a different like Spectrum as a backup and have a backup feed as well. That maybe is half as strong and not, you know, we should probably have a backup on a back. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Like if we have Frontier as our main provider, we should probably have like a Spectrum backup because they usually both don't go down at the same time. Right.
Most likely, no.
Dan, what do you what? Why are you even thinking that we shouldn't do that?
No, I just don't know if they don't both go down at the same time. I just couldn't answer.
We
that
need
part.
That Elon Musk satellite service.
No, you know how expensive that is.
Is it
Starlink?
Expensive? Starlink.
Oh my God, Starlink is so expensive.
Is it really?
Oh, listen, watch. Hey, Alexa. How much?
How are you going to talk to Alexa?
Yeah,
she's not on the internet.
Oh damn it!
That bitch asleep.
I'm looking it up on my phone right now.
Cellular, say it.
Yeah,
we can't. But see, that's how, you know what, Anna, we don't even realize how much we rely on having an internet connection, right?
And I think that's horrible. They charge you commercial prices and they don't give you commercial service.
But isn't it eye-opening, Dan, to let you know, like, we cannot do our job without the internet.
It says Starlink.
That'd be like saying, Dan, you can't do surgery if you don't have a surgical center.
Yeah, or if the, anesthesia machines don't work.
Right.
So the cost on Starlink, there's three offers. First one is residential, which is $110.
No, we're not residential. We're commercial.
Well, if it's a backup.
Well, I mean, don't try to circumvent the system. Just
business see cost, $500 per month with $2,500 one-time equipment fee.
$2,500.
Plus $500 a month.
$500 a month.
Residential. No more salary for Dan.
Residential is actually pretty reasonable. Because ours is always down, $110 per month with $600 one time.
But Bubba, what if you had Starlink Residential, like Lummy said, and like, you know, as
it just gets us up at least.
And then just using it as an emergency.
No, but what I'm saying is, would Starlink even consider making, you know, this is a commercial
address?
Yeah, this is a commercial address in a commercial industrial park. You can't, there's no residential here. And I don't know that they would allow us to register as residential knowing that we're a warehouse. You know what I'm saying?
Probably not.
You know, they probably got, they got Google Earth like everybody else does.
They got Starlink.
They got Starlink.
Yes.
I mean, they're a technology company. You don't think they can completely pinpoint exactly what type of business you are?
Yeah, you think you're going to bamboozle Elon Musk?
Yeah. You don't think that he has 5021 West Nassau stored as a full-blown commercial Jones?
Oh, no. The reason they call it residential is just because it's a little bit slower. And business is 500 Mbps, where the residential is 50 to 100.
Yeah, our business is doing great today.
Yeah.
What do we need?
No, hold on. What would we need? We would need the faster one. Even for a backup, we would need that. Which one? Let me, the 500?
The 500.
And how much is that a month?
500.
2,500, right?
Yep.
2,500 stroke down with a 500 kicker?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
For a backup.
For a backup.
It says
Starlink.
Meanwhile, hold on, Lummy. Hold on, Dan. Meanwhile, Lummy, do this. Look at this. I think Spectrum has a new special out for like commercial fiber or commercial whatever, $49.99, like $50 a month for like 500. That's all we need.
But couldn't you do like a DirecTV type satellite?
That's what Starlink is.
But there's a cheaper version of that though. Like I had it on my boat. It wasn't $500 a month.
No, but why would we even worry about that when we could get, you know, Spectrum Business right now they're offering it for $50 a month.
Yeah, it is. Yep, 600 Mbps speed.
Yes, that's 600.
Well, that's $50 for a 12-month bundle.
What?
12-month, that's what it says. You got to sign up for a year. $50 a month.
All right, so yeah, no problem. We got to sign up for a year. Sign up for 2 years if we need to. It's $50 a month, Dan, and it's 600 up.
So this is how you get a $50 a month. You gotta get a phone, which is $20. And then you get Spectrum Mobile unlimited data free.
So you got to buy a phone too?
Yes,
like a Spectrum phone.
Yes, but it says
burner phone.
Yeah, it's free.
I guess you could just keep it here and make it our show phone.
Show
phone. Make it the show. You know, just keep it right here. And like, you know, whoever knows the number knows the number.
Show phone.
It's a show phone.
Show phone's ringing.
So you're saying you just can't be a business and say, hey, I don't need a phone. I just need, you know, that 600 meg coming in at $50. I'll sign a 1-year deal. How about it?
Yes. That's how you get it.
No. What if I don't want the phone?
Then it looks like it goes up to $99.99.
Okay, get the phone. Get the phone.
Well, you get a free phone or it doubles. Like you have to take the phone.
Yeah,
but does the phone have a bill separate?
No, I don't think so.
Is it like a landline phone or like a cell phone?
You get a landline phone and a cell phone.
We don't need
to get two phones.
But
we don't two need... phones, one for the mom, one for the club.
We don't.
You know that song by Kevin Gates?
So, you know, your home phone is just going to be like solicitors and spam. I mean, so here, you turn that bitch off.
Or not. It might be great entertainment.
Right?
Because, I mean, they're calling me. You know, the only time you really technically legally can get in trouble for telling, you know, for putting people on the air is if you call them. But if they call you,
right,
it's legal to answer the phone. They're calling a radio station,
right?
So
dumbasses.
I mean, and I know the rules. So the bottom line is, if I call somebody, you never notice. I always say, you know,
hey, by the way, people you know, like Reggie.
Reggie, hey, I got you on the air.
Right.
Or even people I'm just trying to trick. I'll even do a real tricky one. Be like, hey, is it okay to be on the air or something? But like, if you call me, I don't have, you're calling a radio station,
yeah,
a call-in station at that. So I don't even have to tell when, you know, mm-hmm, some Hindu dude that's trying to sell me, you know, a car warranty. That goes right live on the air.
You know, right, as soon as you pick up that phone, you hear that background noise of other people talking.
Yeah,
they're
in
some call center.
So, yeah, exactly. In India.
Yeah.
So
oh my God, the IRS is about to raid your house.
I'm reading like that the small. So it looks like you have to sign up for the phone for 2 years.
Yeah, but is the phone?
There's a Tic Tac somewhere in there, Bubba.
That's what I'm looking at.
You probably got to buy the phone from them, which is like $1,000. That's probably what you got to do. You got to buy the phone from them. Well, you know what, Lummy? I just want the $99.99, the $100 a month that I don't have to have a phone and a 2-year contract and buy a phone or anything like that. I don't need no landline. Just all I need is a backup internet. Because if I had a backup internet right now, bam, we would be on the air. Well, we are on the air, but you're hearing us 30 minutes later. We're doing these in 25-minute segments. And then we're... but we can't email them to them, Lummy, because
we're hotspotting them.
We got a little backdoor hotspot deal.
But JVC, so we'll get it to Arizona. And then what Macho Man's working on is having it piped through 820. So 820 will at least have it.
Hold on. This sounded like some Three Stooges plan. You said, after we get it to Arizona, we're going to go ahead and pipe it back to 820 on the back. Like, what?
Yeah, and then Macho Man's going to have 820 streaming it, and then he's going to see if we maybe could stream it to JVC.
If you do a radio show and no one's there to listen to it.
It's really a radio show.
Did you really even do a radio show?
Is this even a show? You know, which just goes to show you how much of an unbelievable skilled craftsman I am as a radio host, is I can get all of us going, participating as if we were on the radio, and we're really not on the radio. That's all because of my leadership skills. Thank you.
You should conduct the next moon landing.
Anna, how you doing?
I'm doing great.
Are you freaked out that we're like maybe on the air?
No, I just feel a little broken today. I was kind of roughed up yesterday.
Really? What happened? Well, obviously
I was rolling.
Right?
Yeah, I was just rolling, and you know, people, they don't go easy sometimes on me.
And this happens, you know. Listen, this happens regularly with you.
Oh yeah.
About every, and I don't keep score, but just tell me. I'm just gonna guess.
Yeah.
But it seems like to me, about every third roll,
yep,
is one of these kind of roles. Like two roles go good, you learn something, you're with somebody that's kind of evenly matched or a little bit better or a little bit less than you guys, and it's kind of, you learn a lot, but you're not beat up, but you had a good workout. And then on that third one is always, oh my God, I got my ass kicked.
Well, it's also just my body's broken down when you do it 3 days in a row. So
right,
on the third day, you're just kind of already sore and just kind of not feeling your best. And then you just get worked.
And then you just...
I just got worked yesterday.
Oh,
I tried to sprawl on some guy, and I'm like, hell yeah. I thought I was going to get him in a guillotine. mother, I almost said the F word. The guy just stood up and I like fell over and like I thought I was going to break my neck. Like it was doing like a handstand thing.
And then in my head, I always say
biological differences. Like there's just nothing I can do.
There's no differences.
Biological differences.
Weight.
Even though the guy was like short, like he wasn't much taller than me.
Weight, strength, right, Dan?
Yeah.
Doesn't matter if you have a penis. Does it make your muscle any stronger?
Yeah, right. So,
Dan, hold on. Let me ask you a question.
Roll if you think there's no biological differences.
But Dan, let me ask you a question, okay? What? As a real doctor, okay? Mm-hmm.
Not a fake one.
As a 130-pound woman, can she develop the same kind of muscles that
130 pounds, by the way.
You know, like, so, no, I'm just using this as an example because that's a small man.
What do you weigh, roughly?
Hold on.
About 115.
Hear me out. 130 mm-hmm. is a small man.
Yes.
But it's a bigger woman.
Right.
Okay, right?
Yeah, depends on her height, but yeah, okay.
Thickish.
So at our species smallest, and at the other species, medium to bigger size.
Yeah, the other species.
Like Dan, could they both develop the same type of muscles?
Never in a million years.
Is it the male muscle just different? Is it just
the male will kick the female 99 times out of 100?
If he goes through puberty correctly, he will.
Yeah, yeah. I'm just saying.
Get puberty blockers. Exactly.
If he's not on Lupron.
I'm just saying, if you took a 13-year-old. If you had two twins, and one was a boy and one was a girl.
Fraternal twins.
Yes, fraternal twins.
Make them 17 years old.
And
18.
Make them 17 years old, and they mirrored each other in height and weight the entire time.
Mm-hmm.
She ended up being a big girl, and he ended up being a small guy.
Right.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, what happens if they do the same amount of weight training, the same amount of training? They, you know, like, he'll kick her ass, won't he?
All day, every day.
And why is that?
Because boy muscles are different than girl muscles.
Men have 20 times on average stronger. As much testosterone as women.
They have so much more testosterone, so much more muscle strength. And Anna can tell you, I mean, just like
she said. It's not even close.
A guy that weighs comparable to her can just stand up and shake her off like she's a flea.
Yeah.
Wow.
I just started laughing.
It's just not, it's not, it's
so this
not,
guy wasn't
it's
like
not
a real
fair.
Big dude or nothing.
It's not fair to women. When biological males are allowed to compete against them, they get hurt. There's a volleyball player last week, I think, or 2 weeks ago, that got knocked out because a biological male transitioning female volleyball player, I think I said that correctly, spiked the ball in her face and it backed her head up so much it knocked her out.
Yeah, broke her nose, concussion. Right?
For real? Nose, was it college?
I think it was high school.
High school? I can't remember if it was high school.
I'll tell you what I want to encourage. This is what I want to encourage. You know, everybody is like the real big hot topic that we've had in the last, I don't know, 3 or 4 years is these men that are transitioning to women and competing in women's sports and kicking their ass.
Mm-hmm.
But I want to vice versa it, and I want to encourage women to start trying out for boy sports.
What, like kick ass and darts?
No, that's about the only game.
Hey, we got cornhole.
I want to see a couple female women that think they're all that, you know, try out for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
Good luck.
I want to see, and the men are told, like, you know, do not hold back. Like,
but they will.
But you know, females have become kickers in some college teams.
There are a few.
The kickoff that went 20 yards.
There's only two potential jobs for a female in football.
Yeah,
a kicker,
coach and trainer.
No, a kicker or a punter.
Yeah,
that's it.
Those aren't the same thing.
Well, no.
Kicker like kicks field goals and kickoffs.
So they're two different positions and two different skill sets too.
Okay.
But most punters are actually pretty. And usually, Lummy, when you're on that level, like McAfee, he started out initially as a field goal kicker and ended up a punter. So if you got the skill set of using your foot to kick a ball, sometimes they can transition. Like I've seen punters turned into field goal kickers, and a lot of times
usually the other way around because field goals a lot of aim and punting's not quite as precise. But do you think like someone like Mia Hamm, the goalie that for the U.S. female soccer
team, off, deal.
Would be able to do a punt? I think she'd be able to punt because she punts soccer balls. She'd probably be a decent punter.
You could probably get. I'd like to get him in there immediately. Mm-hmm. I want the NFL to start having. You know, in fact, you know what we could do. This is what we do. This is the most brilliant idea ever. is Dan, the NFL, you know, as woke as they're trying to be, mm-hmm. right? They were woke mm-hmm. with the national anthem. They've been woke with, they were woke. Hell, they were so woke with Kaepernick that they wrote him an $85 million check.
They're literally pioneers of woke.
So here, if I'm Bubba, what's the guy's name?
Goodell.
Goodell. If I'm Bubba,
he makes like $80 million a year.
Right.
Now.
If I'm Bubba Goodell, I'm be like, I know I'm gonna get a lot of flack back on this, but here's the deal. Here's a new NFL rule.
You don't care. None.
Your kicker has to be a female.
That'd be awesome.
Period.
Wait. Let me ask you this.
The best part is when you break tackles Bubba, the first 10 guys.
I was gonna ask.
Bubba, wait. It's just like Fournette and that chick between the goal line.
Do you want to break a 25?
What?
It's 25.
Do you want to take this over? Yeah, because this is not real live, but I. But isn't that just how brilliant we are? Like, yeah, we just right now thought we were alive.
Wait, so kickers are susceptible to being tackled?
Oh, hell yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
I didn't know. Like, I don't watch football.
If you kick the ball and it ended up being a block, the kicker is a legal player at that point for you to plow.
There'd be women just dead on the field everywhere.
Oh, it'd be so good.
I'd be the best ever.
But, Dan, wouldn't it be the best rule ever that all kickers are female?
That'd be awesome, man.
It'd make me want to watch the game.
Uh-huh.
Because, you know, they could, you know, be like...
You just want that female. You just want that one-on-one.
And all the cheerleaders are trans women, right?
No. But Dan, here's what it does: it shortens the game too.
Sure.
Meaning, you know, you know, now with a guy with an NFL quality guy, you know, 45 to 60, you know, you got guys. You're
40 to 60 all day long.
Yeah, I mean, if you're 48 to 60, most teams, less weather conditions, are gonna probably kicker is good enough to be 50-50. Man, if
what do you mean by 50-50?
I mean 50-50 chance to hit it.
Oh, you're talking about field goals now.
Yes.
I'm talking about punting.
No,
still.
I'm talking about punting. Field goals in the NFL in today's current NFL mm-hmm. between the yards of 45 and 60.
You're right. That's fair game.
Most teams have a guy that's at least 50% on that.
Oh yeah, you'd hope.
So bad, but you know, back in the day, man, after it was 50, man, you know, it was a punt.
Right.
Well, the league's changed and people have gotten stronger.
There's a lot of 58 and 60 yard field goals these days.
Right.
Right. You didn't see that 20 years ago.
A 55 and 60 yard field goal isn't out of the question in today's league.
Right.
Back then they'd be like, well, punt. Like, no way. Mm-hmm. Well, women probably, honest to God, the most baddest ass woman there ever was. Like the
Mia Hamm.
Like Lummy.
Like take a Mia Hamm.
If they
like
would go and find the, you know, the best. I mean, maybe 45, maybe, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So
they have to do a rugby style.
So now it shortens the game, and not all of them are good because you know they're not right.
Why don't we just use pink footballs?
No, make everybody happy. Just saying every kicker in the NFL has to be a girl. That would be the best rule ever.
I sign on to it. I agree.
Anyway, listen, we got to go because this break wasn't really even live. It was taped. And we're sending it to the affiliates now to run.
Through a hotspot.
Through some makeshift hotspot. So I hope that you get to hear, have heard all that. And if not, we just wasted our time.
Believe it or not.
Absolutely not.
Everything you heard about him has been toned down for easier public acceptance. The Bubba the Love Sponge Show returns after these words.
Lummy, so I wanted to do this before I get into my first story. And my first story before that we're going to close this segment out with is Orlando, the radio personality in Tampa.
Davis.
Who's been around nearly as long as I have. I started in 92.
Really?
Yeah, I started in 92. I think he got here in the 90s. I'm probably got 5 years on him here in Tampa. Probably, I do. But him and I used to be friends. Like, we used to be friends. And then he became best friends with Mike Calta, and him and I no longer became friends. And I don't really know of any event that happened or anything like that. But then when I started working for Beasley and they did Bubba 98.7, you know, he's the big swinging D over there on the urban side, 94.1. He's the manager of 94.1.
And the host of the morning show.
And, you know, he's always, when he came into this market, it used to be Wild 98.7. Yeah. And then they changed it over to Wild 94.1. And then in the transformation of 98.7 over the years, I eventually got 98.7 to be Bubba 98.7. And had I not been an idiot and made mistakes, I probably would still have that. But I did make some mistakes, and I own up to it, and I'll be forever paying for it. That being said, when I was over there and Bubba 98.7 was being on the air, it's been told to me, and I know for a fact that he absolutely anytime could get a dig in on me corporately, or he could say something bad about me or to corporate, he would. He was, you know, constantly, you know, saying very not cool stuff about me. So when Carl Harris, my buddy, who was the program director of 98.7.
Good guy.
You love the guy. Worked for me prior. I was the one able to handpick the program director when it was still not Bubba 98.7. When he got fired and they were starting, and I was, you know, only 6 months behind Carl, they had this, remember this 3D kind of Bubba bust? That gold bust that we had.
Got it back in 2008.
Yeah, we got it. It was sent to us as a gift. It was kind of like what's back in the back there, but larger.
Yes, it was.
For me, and it was ours. And you know, we would put it on camera every once in a while, talk about it on the air. Well, Carl had it in his office, and so when he went over there to be the program director in 98.7, he took that with him, you know. And it was in his office. I was his morning man. We're best friends. He formerly worked for me. Well, when he got fired, he forgot to grab that. Orlando took it and gave it to Calta, and Calta has clowned it ever since. They've done, like, you know, glory hole stuff with it, and they keep
defacing it.
Anna, is it
defiling it? Horrible.
Did you not see it when you were over there?
No, I've never heard about it.
It's in Calta's office. He has a bust of me. And Orlando is the one that gave it to him as kind of an FU to me.
Nice.
So anyway, that guy got arrested for a DUI. It was big news.
But it wasn't just like he got pulled over because he was drunk driving. He smashed into another car after running a red.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Did he hurt somebody?
Non-threatening injuries, but still.
So anyway, I do have an opinion about that.
Yeah, not good.
And I'm going to give you my opinion of that here. Well, I might as well just do it now. You're right. Doesn't have to.
Did he try to run or did he stay?
No. He didn't. Listen, he didn't do anything wrong. He didn't.
Except
for
drinking and driving.
Well, he didn't. Listen. He didn't do anything wrong. He was drinking and driving, which is wrong. And he smashed into somebody's side of the car.
Which is wrong.
And thank God the people that were in the car, it was the head news story. Here's channel. Here's channel 10's little video piece of it. I'll have to sit through. I had it all ready to go too. But you know, if you let it go too long,
they'll get you with that pre-roll.
They'll get you. Yeah. I mean,
said, hey, it's been a little too long since you've seen an advertisement.
Mm-hmm. See, you know, we know that you gamed the system. We know that you watched us 30 minutes ago, and you're putting us on hold so that you can refer to us again without. But we're gonna stick another pre-roll on you, buddy. You held on too long, kid.
For the
Hold on. Here's the pre-roll.
All right.
Here we go.
Oh.
Popular radio show host Orlando Davis, known as Orlando, was arrested early this morning after police say he was driving under the influence. Tampa police say Wild 94.1 host caused significant damage to the other vehicle after running a red light at the intersection of Northdale Mabry Boulevard and West Kennedy Boulevard. He was charged with one count of DUI with property damage or physical injury. Davis has since bonded out.
All right, so that's what happened. And if you're a radio guy in Tampa and you've been around long enough, you know, and you're relevant and you're somewhat known, then you're going to get, when you do stupid stuff, trust me, I'm at the top, very top of that list. When you do stupid stuff or you're going to court, they're trying to put you in prison. Think about all the news coverage I've gotten in this town and why.
Wait, hold on a second. You originally said that he didn't do anything wrong. There was an argument there, and I was waiting for the next piece of that.
I'm gonna get into that. Okay.
Got a message.
All right. Did somebody send me something on the? Did somebody send me a?
No, I think that's a different sound.
Yeah, I don't know what sound that was.
I don't know what.
Want to listen to their show a little?
I don't know.
I do.
I don't know where those sounds are coming from. Sorry. So shut up so I can get into my deal here.
All right.
So anyway, it's a big story here in town, and I'm sure everybody's talking about it. And this guy has, of all the radio personalities that potentially could be, now there'll be some radio personalities that are not allowed to talk about this. I don't know. I'm just saying, I don't know if the 98 Rock, 98 Rock may say you guys can't talk about it. I'm sure Couch is talking about it in a very pro, Orlando's my buddy. I love him. He's okay.
Everyone makes mistakes.
Everybody makes mistakes. Yippee-yo. Okay, that's probably his spin on the deal. Mm-hmm. I don't know. And then everybody is like, oh, man, I wonder what Bubba's going to say. Because this guy has been the biggest dick to me. This of all the radio person and how we all get along in town, which is pretty much everybody hates me. I mean, that's kind of the common denominator. Everybody, I can't think of anybody in radio that doesn't hate me in this market.
I don't hate you.
I can.
Well, no, there are a few. Here's the thing. Anna knows this firsthand. You have to act like you hate me.
Oh, there's some sleeper cells, but they're out there.
That's the thing. Corporately, if you work at Cox, Beasley, or iHeart, you have to corporately, if asked or in it, you have to not like me. Like, I am the bad guy. You hate him. But I do have some people in radio, hosts, actually radio hosts, that I wouldn't say are fans of the show.
Would.
Well, I would just say appreciate, what I've brought to Tampa, appreciate my show.
But still listen.
And I would say maybe at least say like my show.
Austin Yeager, 20 on the Cash App.
You know, they like the show. They like the show. We might even be their favorite, morning show.
Mm-hmm.
In Tampa. They're a Tampa radio personality and their favorite radio, who they listen. I know that when I used to be on 98, when I was on the Power Pig at night, 93.3 FLZ at night, and on Mondays we had jock meetings at 10 a.m., which means I lived in Palm Harbor at the time. I had to leave at about 9 or 8.50 just because you can't be late to make sure I got there by 10. And we had every Monday morning, and it was my only downfall of my job, is every Monday morning I had to be at the station by 10 o'clock. And that would be, so every Monday, Anna, I went from 9 until 10, I would be able to switch to all the morning shows and listen to who, and at that time, it was Ron and Ron. And then after Ron and Ron left, it was, my station, the Power Pig, the Three Little Pigs that I would listen to. But, as a radio guy, you kind of scan the radio dial, and you're familiar with who's on what channel and who's good and who's legendary and who's not and who's done what. I mean, as a radio. And so I used to listen to Neil Rogers, too, out of Miami. And he was on AM 620. It was like a really you really had to be a radio nerd to know where Neil Rogers was. And you really have to be a radio nerd to understand and even know how brilliant Neil Rogers was as a talk show host. His cynical, Jewish, prima donna, closeted homosexual, his cynical delivery. And he was one of the best talk show hosts of all time. And he was actually piped into Tampa. So I get to listen to him after the meeting will last like an hour. So I drive back, to Palm Harbor around 11:30, and then I could catch the Neil Rogers show. And then after Neil, they had a midday show called Hooters on the Radio. And when the original Hooters on the Radio, which was on AM 1010, yep. The original Hooters with Lynn Austin, Julie Williams, and BL, they were so funny. They were so good. So, everybody in Tampa radio knows everybody. And they know... And very well, their favorite morning show may not be the morning show they're associated with. And their favorite afternoon show may not be the show they're associated with. You'd be surprised if you knew who my favorite afternoon drive show. Hell, I'll just tell you. Drew and John Sinning why sit here and act like, I got to do what got me to the dance, and that's be honest. Mm-hmm. Just be transparent. I'm probably the only guy on the radio that truly can, and anybody else is just a ripoff or stole my job like a thief. That being said, I'll just flat out say it. Drew and John Sinning are my afternoon drive show. Or middays, I don't really listen. I don't ever listen in the middays. I couldn't tell you who my favorite midday program was. But, you know, mornings would be us. Afternoons would be Drew and John Sinning. And then at night, I don't really listen much. I listen to the night show sometimes on 102.5, and I wish I could have some time with them to make them better. They make so many mistakes, so many correctable mistakes, and they have so many correctable crutches. I could make them so much better if I could sit down with one air check session with those dudes.
During
the midday, I do listen to Rome.
I was going
to
say Jim Rome, yeah.
I do listen. If I happen to be in my car during the midday, I listen to Jim Rome. So anyway, that's my Tampa radio knowledge and my opinion. And if you don't like it, I'm so sorry. But chances are, if you're Bubba Army, you do like that. That's probably what you like. So here's this guy, Orlando, who's been in the market a long, long time. He's caused some issues with some people. He hates me. He's publicly let it know how much he hates me. He tried to get me fired a couple times when I was at Bubba 98.7. We had some kind of issue at a promo. It was like boys and toys, and they asked me to bring. It was like toys. It was like Dan. I forget what it was. It was something to do with like cars and cool stuff for kids. Kids and cars or something like that. And they asked me to bring Tyler's sprint car as, you know, kind of not a novelty, because, you know, you would see like
something interesting.
Yeah. They had bounce houses and Ferraris and I don't know what the hell they had.
Yeah, it was kids. It's kids and cars.
Yeah. And so I brought Tyler's sprint car there and displayed it. And I guess he was there on part of 94.1 and he said something or did something. It ended up being a little bit of a big dust up corporately. And so whatever. I don't listen to his show because I'm on during the same time. I think he's marginally talented as a host. And I think that urban format where you have some crutches and some, almost like Charlemagne the God kind of deal. Like you're a kind of a wannabe, hack version of Charlemagne the God. Huh. You know, you got your girl over there, which, by the way, the girl on the show is pretty hot.
Meredith?
Yeah, I think she's hot.
Mm-hmm.
I really do. And then I guess I got a new guy.
On Orlando show? Meredith?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
I'd rather see DUI pictures of hot chicks than this guy.
Yeah, man, I'd rather see a bikini shot of her than this guy. So anyway, this guy has been not cool to me at all. At all. And he gets arrested for a DUI. And here's my message to you. Orlando, go get some help, bud. And I hope corporate doesn't screw with you too much and make you do a bunch of stupid stuff. And, I hope everything works out for you. I don't wish anything harm. I don't wish any harm on you. You know, maybe this is an intervention or a life lesson that, maybe you have a drinking problem, or maybe you drink and drive a lot or something like that. Maybe this will be a rude awakening to that, and this will be a life lesson. I will tell you, as arrogant and cocky as I ever got, it took me, getting knocked down a few pegs for me to understand and appreciate what I have.
He's a fellow Hoosier, too.
I know. If Gary, Indiana, I know everything about mm-hmm. him. Gary, Indiana, went to IU, has two kids. We were friends at one time until he... he's a big Celta guy. So
think it would be appropriate to send him a gift certificate to Uber?
That'd be a funny flex.
That's actually pretty funny, Dan. Let me give him a pop. But listen, Orlando, I wish you the best. I'm not going to sit here and make fun of you. I just, know that I'm gonna take the high road with you. And I wish you the very, very best, my friend. And, hopefully corporate doesn't use this and the trolls don't get a hold of your clients and it ends up, because if it was me and I had done something wrong, the next thing you know, the trolls get a hold of all my clients. Hell, the trolls, some of which you probably know, used to get a hold of all my clients and get me canceled when I wasn't even doing anything wrong just for being Bubba the Love Sponge.
Yeah, but you're like Trump, man. You're very polarizing. You're very famous. You destroy everyone around you. You're by far the best guy in the Tampa Bay, let alone Florida, let alone country as a DJ. So this is like, you getting arrested would be like Trump getting arrested. Him getting arrested is like the congressman from like Live Oak getting arrested because he's a nobody. So it's not going to get the same kind of coverage that you would get because you're a superstar and he's like, you know, a dim white dwarf.
What?
It's a star that doesn't shine brightly. It's called the white dwarf.
That's smart guys talk.
White dwarf.
It's a type of star.
It's a type of star. It's a dim star.
I don't know if that would be very appropriate at all in this particular situation.
Well, it doesn't matter the color. It's just the dimness.
But it kind of does.
It's the brightness.
It kind of does.
Okay. Oh, just a dwarf. He's a dwarf.
A star.
A dwarf star. A dwarf star. What are they called? Are they called white dwarfs? I think they're called white dwarfs.
I think you're right.
It just kind of says.
But it's not like you're like a supernova, you know? Well, you're like the champagne supernova.
Okay, well, Orlando, good luck to you, buddy. And there is a thing called karma, I guess. All you guys that keep screwing with me, all you radio personalities keep, but I'm still standing. And I ain't going nowhere. And I'm making a living. And we're doing good shows. And I've established a digital infrastructure of which you have not. So I don't know, you know, listen, keep up your big time terrestrial gigs. All you haters and all you guys that have done stuff to me or against me or you know, whatever. There's a lot of them. It's because you're all jealous of me and you guys all think that I'm, you know, I just fell into this. And that it's not because I'm better than you. You hate to admit that I'm better than you. You just hate to admit it. It just kills you. To see the levels that I of radio that I've done, who I was handpicked by, how yeah. At the end of the day, this is why they really hate me. Lemmy, this is why a lot of the radio industry hates me.
Because yep. they hate me.
Well,
being you.
You know what? Because the best and you can say that he's lost a little bit and he doesn't do the same type of radio that he used to, and that is Howard Stern. But you are so tore up because he's. Listen. For all of radio, no matter what era, 10 years, 20, 40, 100 years from now, if radio's even still around, I mean, radio literally could be as 10 years from now, you know what? Literally, I read an article, and I'm a true radio historian. They're saying literally that radio could be as uncool as CB radio in 10 years. That's what.
Except you need an activity that you don't need to look at while you're driving. There has to be an activity in your car that you can do while driving, and you can't watch three-dimensional, you know, in-person virtual reality videos while you're freaking driving. You need to listen to something while you're driving.
And most people run their audio through their dashboard. What I'm trying to say is you don't have to have an FM button on. I mean, I'm just telling you, United States government had to step in this year, Dan, and mandate that automakers don't dump AM. Automakers were collectively trying to not be like OEM federally required to include AM radio. Before last year, they're like, we need AM radio in case there's a natural disaster happens. We have to be able to commandeer the radio stations. We do have a national broadcasting system where every radio station. Did it happen during 9/11 and during the Pearl Harbor deal? But I mean,
it probably happened closer to Pearl Harbor than it did 9/11.
But what I'm saying is,
it's probably one of those systems that the best way to communicate to the country is through AM.
We as a country have the ability. To take over, the government has the ability at the hit of one button to take over every radio station in America. If you don't know what I'm talking about, if you hear those tests, if you listen to regular radio, every 30 days they have to run what they call an emergency broadcast system test. And they have to pick a different hour each month. You know, there's like, you know, it can't be always, you do it at 3 a.m. every month. That way nobody, you know, you're not really interrupting. You know, primetime radio. Well, they, you know, so they run a thing. You guys, we've all heard of that. They've streamlined it since the old days. Man, back in the old days, it used to be like almost signing on to AOL. It's like, now they've streamlined it, but it's testing that radio station's emergency broadcast system. So, the government throws down these tones and your station picks it up, and then they've tested it, and they know that works. That's so that the government literally can take over every radio station in America, AM and FM, and broadcast any type of message they need to get to the people. Right? That's, yep. You know.
Is that, now, does that system work simultaneously with the TV's version? Or is that separate?
They probably have a TV version.
You know, you get those same kind of things on
right.
TV.
They have the ability to do it for TV too. Yes, it's probably a different. Linked. It's a different probably department. Mm. I don't know. But anyway, they can do it to the TV. Well, America has always thought, well, we need that AM real estate to be able to really, really. The government feels they don't need AM anymore. They got texts. You know, they got your cell phone. Right? I mean, Dan, now they can put it over your cell phone and they don't need AM.
Right.
So that was the government's argument, and it won, and it had to get appealed, and they overturned it. So AM got a 1-year reprieve. They'll do again and vote for it again next year. So AM got a 1-year reprieve. Well, that's where radio's headed.
It looks like they're trying to pass a bill that forbids automakers from removing AM radio for lifetime. For
yeah,
right
I
now.
Know. That, I mean, they just got a 1-year reprieve on an appeal. But, I mean, as we fast forward, let's say when I started kind of going digital in 2017. So what is that, six years?
6 years.
6 years? Well, I mean, it's taken me 6 years to build what we got. Taken me 6 years. And I have, you know, BubbaArmyRadio.com, and I have archives, and I have... You know, all of this stuff. I own all of this stuff. It's mine. A lot of these radio hosts, Anna, you know, you're probably closer to it to me. A lot of these radio hosts, these long form monologue, you know, not just music jock radio hosts, but like long form monologue. I don't know that they own that content for the ability to be able to put it somewhere else that benefited them.
They do not.
So then what do you have to do? You got to start with from show one. Mm-hmm. With no subscribers, you know, nothing. You're starting with nothing. So good luck to all of you out there, all of you local radio guys that talk smack about me, because I mean, I've reverse engineered it. You need to be where I am. Yeah, I may not be the morning guy on 98 Rock in Tampa, which I wish I was, because you all be in trouble. I promise you that.
They'll be on YouTube doing DoorDash here soon enough.
Yeah, but bitch, I'm telling you. When you get replaced with AI, I mean, that's coming.
DJ, absolutely, man. AI blows it away.
For you radio personalities, man, they're not hiring. Let me just tell you that. Read the trades. They're not hiring. They're just letting people go, and maybe some people are getting syndicated. They're spreading the peanut butter thin, and they're going to keep these syndicatable personalities that can do, you know, 8, 9, 10 markets, and they're going to get rid of you. They're going to get rid of you. Just being the number one guy locally anymore eventually is going to catch up to you.
Yeah, you're about as relevant as a floppy disk.
If you're the number one rated guy in Tampa, like Orlando is, he's one of the top three every ratings period. He's one of the top three at all time. Been doing it for a long, long time, and it's not even that big of a story. I guess you're pretty much right, Dan.
Mm-mm.
Pretty much, you know.
He's nobody.
Well, he just became somebody because I talked about him. Oh, my God. He got me.
Oh, he got a pop.
At least you got something, bud. I wish you the best. I hope Beasley doesn't screw with you, make you go to, like, you know, corporately. Like, what happens when you get a deal? I mean, what happens
when
you
get a deal?
If he says he's got a problem, then they'll put him in some kind of rehab, and, you know, he just cries. It's like, it's not my fault. It's my problem. It's my.
I mean,
condition.
Does he do that? Does that take
his responsibility? It's all because they have something else going on. You know, this is, you know, a product of my, you know, a genetic weakness I have because I'm just a weak snowflake.
I just sent you the.
It's not me. It's my.
I don't even really know what Dan says. What Dan just said.
You understand what I'm saying?
You listen live top right.
Well, I think they could have maybe. Hold on. Let me just stop.
Okay.
So he's dropping the mic. Okay. All right.
He's dropping the mic.
Yeah. That's what that is.
Her head's bigger than his head.
Stop. Just Dan. I don't know who decided to do this animation. You guys should just have taken a normal picture because Meredith, you guys have, she's really pretty.
Really? She,
I mean, she's very, she's
not
very,
there.
I'm, what I'm saying is you didn't do her any justice at all because she is hot.
Right.
She is, I'm just telling you, she's an attractive woman.
He looks prettier than her.
Shadow's got the best of her on that one.
And it looks like, man, the person that wanted to maybe approve of this one was Orlando because they really, really make him look like a
sexy
million bucks compared to what, I mean, look, did I click out of the story already? Let me maybe send me the story again. I can go side by side comparison to what his booking photo looks like.
Yeah, don't look like that.
Compared to that. And meanwhile, she, on the other hand, you guys really didn't do her any justice because she's a very beautiful woman, and you guys completely buried her, like by making Orlando look. Did you send it to me?
I sent it to you. Yep.
By trying to use the one that made Orlando look the best, you really, really didn't do. You really didn't do Meredith any justice at all. There you go. Man, Dan, can we send him a Botox certificate, too?
Yes, absolutely. I need a Botox.
And an Uber.
And I can send her some horse dewormer.
No, Dan.
Oh, what?
Jesus. First of all, you're going to say you're sorry.
I'm sorry.
Because she is hot.
Okay.
Take my word for it.
Okay.
So, I mean, like, for real.
All right.
Like, don't dog Meredith.
Okay.
She is hot. They jobbed her out.
That sucks.
Anna, when we come back.
Did this picture with Anna, you'd make her look good.
You
make her look all sexy with her big hair and, hide her earlobes.
I just photoshopped that one she uses for Anna Hum Alive. God dang,
nice
that's
picture.
The best shot ever.
Right.
Thank you.
Yeah,
I mean,
exactly.
I'm just saying, Anna, we're going to do like a little group deal. Can I use, and we got a graphic artist that can do it all, so can I just use that really hot shot of yours?
Yeah, absolutely.
You're good at that?
Yep.
I kind of put you over my back left shoulder a little bit. Have you sitting by Dan, Lummy on the other side, Red on the other side. Trying to think how it would go. It'd go me in the middle, then it would be probably Dan to my left and Lummy to my right, and then maybe Anna and then Rhett. Kind of, and you got to put the Macho Man in there.
Yeah,
maybe it's us looking over him bench pressing 500 pounds. maybe
I'm sure he'd love that.
Yeah.
In post, we can just make Macho three times bigger than everybody else.
In post, just make Macho literally just look like a
giant.
Like we just like he's holding us in his hand,
so
like little people in his hand.
Let me go to words. Anna, I have the balls. I don't know that any other radio shows. This is kind of really shows you got balls when you're another radio show, and you go listen to another one live on your airwaves.
Mm-hmm.
Like that's got ball. Like that's Dan Diaco. Look how big my balls are.
Right.
And what are you going to do about it? And I used to be that way, and I'm starting to get my balls back. I'm getting my balls back.
No, Bubba's balls are back.
I'm getting them back. I'm not nearly as hardcore as I used to be, but I'm going to try to be a little more hardcore. See, I opened up this segment and said I was going to be a nice guy. Now I'm over to the hardcore Willie.
Right, with big nasty balls.
With big balls. We're going to check in on our... Maybe I should call him live.
Why not? Because you got AC/DC balls, man. Let's go for it.
It's a sign. The end times are here. Ultra powerful hurricanes, tsunamis, massive earthquakes, and Bubba the Love Sponge.
Sorry.
There's nothing sexy or glamorous about this broadcast.
Just press play.
Bubba the Love Sponge.
You're listening to the Bubba the Love Sponge Show.
Now, because we got the biggest balls of all, and I don't care, and I'm not afraid to expose my listeners to hacks that you'll never go and, watch or listen to. Like, I'm not going to lose any listeners over this guy. I promise you that. I'm not giving this guy giving this guy a zillion a percent, promotion on my huge network. And everybody is going to now know a little bit about you, but trust me, you suck so bad that nobody's going to want to listen to this nonsense. So that's when I can go live to your show and see what, how your show sounds. It's unheard of. Not a lot of radio personalities have, there are some. Ron and Ron would do it. Howard would do it. I would do it. But over the years, there's probably been only four or five radio personalities in the history of radio that will go live to their competition and rebroadcast their competition live on their airwaves.
Wireless, 10662 New East Bay Road.
So I'm going to be honest with you now.
Monday, July 20.
These are commercials, and they were doing commercials before we even went into commercials.
To get the care you're
buying. And our breaks are 6 minutes and 20 seconds long, and they were playing at least a minute. So what are their 8, 9, 10 minute breaks?
Well, at least the way that we had it at Cox's, you could adjust it yourself.
Looks like we might actually get them live. Whatever. By the way, they've already played six songs this hour.
Expressway just past 78th.
So how much of a talk show host are you if you've already played six songs this hour?
Slow southbound US 19 approaching Tampa Road.
Good Monday morning, everybody. Our temperatures in the 70s and 80s.
Hey, standard top 40 radio.
Hey, good morning. Temperatures in the 70s and 80s this morning.
Going to tell you about traffic, then news. I mean, traffic, then weather, then maybe some sports.
Four. Isolated storms.
I'm just, some jobber that works for the channel TV station that we have a barter deal on.
I'm meteorologist Greg D for ABC Action News and Wild 94.1.
Research says
Wild 94.1.
We serve it up three times a day. Listen for the cash register sounder and call.
More music. So listen, since 6 o'clock, they played Die for You. At 6:20, they played Area Codes. At 6:22, they played Under the Influence. At 6:31, they played.
I love that song. It's so fitting.
What is it?
Chris Brown. I love that song. Influence. Baby, who cares? I know you care.
I mean, wouldn't Under the Influence be kind of a rib if you're playing that for...
Exactly. These logs are made way in advance.
Mm-hmm. I know, that's what
you
I'm
got
saying.
A fast car, Tracy
Chapman. If I'm Orlando, I'd be like, man, for really, man, somebody scheduled in this song for after...
The day
after I got arrested for DUI.
Mm.
So now they're playing Workout.
They be trying to keep me down.
So is the guy... I mean, Dan. No wonder he's a nobody. He never gets to talk.
Yeah, he's silent.
Like, I mean, he's played. Okay, since his show started at 6 o'clock, he's played 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Is this now? What song is this? Workout by J. Cole, or is this another song?
No, this is
song?
A different song.
All right, so yeah, they have an updated.
It is J. Cole though.
They have an up. Okay, this is All My Life.
Yeah,
all right.
J. Cole.
This is all
jokes on us if they're just playing music all morning.
I know, it's probably what they're doing.
They may not have the backup show ready to go.
Right.
They're probably just playing music.
Is he even... Right. Well, okay, well,
Hey, 1-800-ASS-SCARY.
Hey. Well, hold on now. I just... Why are you making me do this now? I just did this.
You scared and confused?
But I just did this before I signed on the first time. Now, why just in the... Is this a mid... Are they giving me a mid-roll? Are they giving me a mid-roll Willie hair?
Yeah.
It's Raj from 1-800-ASS-SCARY.
Kind of a long song.
Oh, it is?
Yeah.
Yeah, but we've been 3 minutes. I mean...
I know.
Go ahead, put a hit out. And another one.
So, dear Orlando, do you ever get a talk buddy?
Well, I don't know if they're doing this because of the situation.
Well, see, that's bad. He should be there first thing Monday morning, right, Dan? Laying it all out, right?
He's hungover.
Yeah, but you know how corporate it is.
He's hungover. He's got a headache.
You know, but what I'm saying...
He needs some months to rehab.
But what I'm saying is, like, Orlando, I hope Radio 101 is you're there today... And you're laying it all out. What happened?
Nah, he's a victim, man. He's at rehab. He's getting treatment. It's not his fault.
No. Use your show.
It's his condition.
But use your show to say I have a problem.
Mm-hmm.
Use your show to say I'm going to rehab. Use your show to say I'm sorry to the people I hit.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Don't just lock it up and go on like.
Well, let me ask you a question about radio history because I wasn't around for this.
I'm going to keep this kind of low. And if they talk, just shut up real fast. We'll go up to them. Okay.
Okay.
Right,
go ahead. I believe there was a story several years ago where maybe a radio personality was found perusing the streets of Nebraska Avenue.
Yeah, Galvin. He got picked up for hooker.
Oh, I didn't say that. But how did Cox handle that? Did they get in front of it?
Nothing.
Did they not mention it?
Oh, no. He mentioned it and it blamed it on... He said it was like... She solicited him.
Oh, of course.
And
hookers do that. No, they pay guys to
have
sex.
Even though the Tampa police report said that that's not the way it went down. And hold on. He said she asked him if he wanted, to party. And of course he said yes. And then they arrested him when really the police report says that he rolled the window down, asked her if she wanted a party.
Your confession of seven is on the way.
Oh, confession of seven.
From a modern mom. I don't think y'all... I don't want anybody judging anybody, but we got that for you next after Cardi. Hold on. I want to get
married. Like- so that... So,
huh. So 7 that? O'clock, you'll who's get a pre-recorded talking? Segment.
Yeah. So at 7 o'clock, they have this... They're probably recording it right now. Or they've already recorded it. And it's, what is it called, confession at 7?
I think that's what they said, yeah.
And
yeah.
Really? Do you get radio, do you get callers to call in and say, hi, my name's Johnny, and I'm blasting, you know, the wife, the girl next door?
Yeah, kind of.
Or is it confessions from them?
Hey, I'm Scott from down the hall. I mean, Naples. You'll never believe what I did this weekend.
Yeah, it looks like they take phone calls or they get a phone call. And then,
what about Confession 7, where the host confesses to driving drunk Saturday night?
I actually had 17.
It'd be a pretty funny bit if they had him call in.
Can I tell you what I would do, man? I would say if just how I think radio wise is I would say, you know what, Confessions at 7. Are going to be we're going to do something a little bit different this week, and we're going to talk about I'm going to confess on the situation that's going on. I have a problem, and we're going to talk about that. That's going to be the confession at 7 segment. Mm-hmm. And then you just get in front of it. You're like, hi, you know what? I have a problem. I drink too much. I irresponsibly drive the majority of the time. And, you know, I'm not going to sit here and lie. It's, I can only blame one person, and that's me. Mm-hmm. And,
I don't know if that's a move with advertisers.
And I'm going to go get help. That's where the advertisers, I'm going to go get help. I've entered into a such and such and botch and blotch and blippy blip. And I'll be spending the next, you know, 6 weekends over at, I'll make you better house.
Better house?
Better house. There you go. Better house.
Yeah. I can see why they're going to just brush this under the rug.
I know, but Anna, don't you think like that would be like, that's something
honestly,
you could,
that no.
would be
cool. It'd be cool for us as the listeners, but for the company.
Oh. Yeah, but hold on. That is the difference of what regular radio has become. What's best for corporate or what's most entertaining for the listeners? Nobody cares about the latter. Nobody cares
profits.
Nobody cares about the transparency.
Not losing advertisers.
And having a radio personality that you know is honest and will say it it is and is transparent and is the people's hammer and like, you know.
No doubt it would be way, way better radio and way more entertaining, and you would feel like you could actually connect with people because of being vulnerable, you know, in a public way. But that would never happen because they don't want advertisers to drop.
But they don't understand, Anna. Is that what you just said? That's what people would rally behind it. Like, you know, you take a bad thing.
Yeah, but the people aren't paying the bills, the advertisers are.
So you get an advertiser that wants to leave, and you're like, you know what? We're sorry you're leaving, but we're a little bit disappointed that you don't understand that Orlando
you just call the advertiser
has a problem.
That's cool.
You have a problem with an African-American man having a drinking problem who's trying to better himself. I'm sorry you guys are going to pull our hat. Yeah. Ooh. That makes it,
they're
the Farrah and Farrah Accident Attorney Studios.
The same ones that Orlando called on Saturday night.
You think you're going to play their normal Amazing Monday Media Group Station. Game?
Orlando and the Freak Show will hear your confession. And just like a priest, you're probably going to have to do something after.
But it ain't penance.
Confessions at 7 on Wild 94.1.
All right, Confessions at 7, Confessions 87 at wild941.com comes from a modern mom. It says, Dear Freak Show.
Email only?
I need you to please put your judgmental emotions away for a second because I want you to hear the entire situation first. I recently got divorced and it was a difficult decision.
Again, just somebody that some copywriter wrote. Like, this isn't a real email from somebody. This is all made up, right? The only thing that's ever real is phone calls, and those can sometimes be from the guy three doors down that does middays on QYK.
Yeah. Ask me.
Right? Mm-hmm. I mean, the only thing is real, raw phone calls, unedited, not people from within your business that you pay to do it.
So they can know.
They just write these emails to be the most high spot ever, most drama ever, so that Orlando and the show can break it down.
Daughter, here you go. During the week, and I get to see her every other weekend. When anyone hears that, they immediately judge me and think, how could a mother do that to their child? It just works better for me this way, and I'm happier. And he is, too, because he's really built for this. It seems that he was made to be a dad, and I'm not really there yet.
Okay. Like, do you think that there's really a that well-versed of a woman that can write a letter that's listening to his show?
I now look forward to seeing her instead of the dismay that I felt before.
Or is this written by, you know, somebody that works at Wild 90, one of the sales managers from Wild 94.1?
I thought it'd be something to share. Because
some inner office, you know, like, yeah. You Anna, a girl that Anna, go be a chick that's sad about losing their kid to a part-time daddy that Orlando can read on Monday morning, okay?
Yeah, no problem.
Wonder
what let it out?
Because she's over here just...
I was like, I'm trying to figure this out. Is there a way to, like, reword I gave up full custody so it doesn't sound so bad from a mother's standpoint?
Just because she
it's
wants...
It's rare.
Oh, hold on. Talk about a bunch of biters going right to our family law segment, right? Mm. I mean, you know, right?
Yeah.
Just like other...
So is Orlando talking? That's not Orlando. That's the other guy?
No, that's Orlando.
Full-time parent or even have a, you know, share custody,
that's girl,
basically.
That's
okay, but
the
here's...
That's Orlando.
I don't know. I don't know.
I mean, okay, first of all, nobody should be...
That's Orlando right there.
But again, the confession, that's all we do is judge. And people know that when they write in, but... You immediately...
When they write in. Nobody's allowed to call in now. Because, right? Nobody's allowed to call in. The real stuff where you get the real problems. Mm. The real people.
So, because you immediately you think that. Girl so, that somebody's dating...
You think a girl that abandoned her children uses the word dismay?
Yeah.
Where people are like, hey, do you have your kids every other weekend? Because let's sync up our days or whatever. So if we want to go out.
And they're going to like the most mass appeal female based question. Like this is all strategic based on their audience they're trying to attract or keep.
I ask you what your schedule is. Because,
you know, like, you know, us, we'd be like, hey, Bubba, this is Jim. And you guys were talking about those penis pumps. And do they really work? Do they really work? Does Dan really, really addicted to his penis pump for real?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah. Those are our kind of emails. Dear Bubba, my girl, I just can't get her I just can't get her to jet ski. Can you go ahead and tell me how to do that again? Please.
Mention. I think that's great. We're talking about her. I feel like I can't not judge this. I'm sorry.
Out of the 941,
really trying.
They're saying, I'm judging her.
She asked you not to.
I know.
Yeah. Out of 941, she said, I'm judging her. She don't want to be a parent. She wants to be
See, they only communicate with their listener via text.
Right. She don't want to be a parent.
No, but hold on, though.
But that's who's answering the question. That's how they answer the question.
I know. But more importantly, they don't even have the ability to go. They don't. Mm-hmm. I guess they want to be able to strategically place what goes over the air because... Sometimes Anna will tell you. I mean, the phones can be the Wild West. Mm-hmm. I mean, you know, you got to be quick on your feet. You're going to get
not if you don't take live calls.
Exactly.
Active one at school.
And not even during your contesting do you take live calls. Even during major segments, major appointments that you do, the Confession 7, a major, major, major part of your show every day is not even really, really real. It's contrived. It's all made up.
I have a new email. Dear Orlando Fake Show in the Morning, what do you think about letting my ex-husband drive my kids around after he got a DUI and almost killed someone in a car accident last weekend?
Should his custody be somewhat questioned of my children?
Yeah, that's
never really
see email.
Anybody back. I'm like, his mom's...
Dear Orlando, I heard you did a breath re... I'm sorry. My dad, my baby's daddy...
My baby daddy.
My baby daddy got a DUI this weekend and a mugshot, and he's refused to do the breathalyzer. It was breathalyzer refusal.
Really?
So I think that's an instant... You lose your license for a year.
Right.
So my baby daddy now has lost his license for at least a year, and I have to work. How are we going to get these kids back and forth? Should baby daddy, you know, not be able to see his daughters anymore? Thank you. A concerned mom from Apopka. Oh, back over to music.
Sap said there was one light in Apopka when he was a kid.
So, you know, hey, good luck to you, Orlando. I mean, I think refusal means you're not going to have a driver's license for a year. But if you get a good attorney, they could probably get you a hardship, Willie, where you can go to and from work. But I don't think, you know, Ebor or hard telling where you were coming from. He was right around the corner. He was at
Dale Mabry and Kennedy.
Dale Mabry and Kennedy. Like, where are you coming back from there, Price?
Friday. It was a Friday, like
Dale
Saturday morning at 2 a.m.
Mabry and Kennedy, which is really close to There's a spaceship.
Oh yeah, hell yeah.
Or across the UFO. Across the way from there.
Yeah, you know what I mean, there's probably, but there might be an urban club down by there, you know, somewhere there too.
Sure, sure.
You know,
it's called the Champagne Room.
So, I mean, I don't know where you're coming from, but you know, good luck to you. Hopefully, you're transparent enough to get on the air today and tell the people. I got to tell you,
well, he's on the air.
I got to tell you, Orlando, as a fellow radio host, who you may not appreciate or not, I have far more credibility and a better name in this business as far as being a big time talk show host than you do. You're a disc jockey. You play records. You play 8 or 9 or 10 records an hour, and you're allowed to talk. I mean, I talk. What's 1 hour minus
48 minutes?
12. Yeah, I talk 48 minutes a show. You probably talk 8 minutes.
Yeah, 4 to 8.
48 minutes an hour.
Four to eight.
Yeah, I'm sorry. An hour. I've talked 48 minutes an hour. What's 48 times 4, Dan?
Oh God. Now it's like 96, 192.
I talk
182.
I talk 192 minutes per show. Lock in. Like, we don't play records here. You're not really a talk show host. You're a DJ that can be replaced. You may think you're all that, my friend. But, I mean, this is just the sort of thing, man, that... I mean, the guy's making a lot of money.
Is he?
Because he's been there for a long time, yeah. And, I mean, this is the sort of thing that maybe Beasley fires you for. Right?
Those DUIs cost money.
Oh, well, that's going to cost him at least 10 grand. What if you saw, see, but you need to get... Orlando, you need to get ahead of this, buddy. You need to say, hi, I'm Orlando, I need help. And I'm telling you, it'll make your ratings go through the roof.
Yes.
Especially, you dumbass, if you promote it saying, this is what you know. I used to be in urban radio, so I got the credibility. I could do this kind of thing. Okay, I don't want anybody to think like this is like, you know, not beyond my capabilities, because I used to be like him. I used to have to be that guy.
Every other weekend. And she said it's helping her get a life. Plus, she's looking forward to seeing the baby girl. There are a lot of...
This sounds like your ex-wife's letter to the station.
This one here, out of the A13. The sad reality is, it says, I'm okay with her decision, and I support her. If my marriage ended...
Look how fake he's being. Like, everybody that's texting, anybody that's listening to the show right now, what do you think they want him to talk about?
Anything but his DUI?
No. Oh. His DUI, they want his side of the story, right?
Well, yeah, because
on the other side of it, these hoochie...
What?
It's obviously voice tracked.
It's either grandma or dad with the...
So you don't even think they're there right now?
I don't think it's live, no.
Yeah, this is probably all old stuff.
Doing nothing wrong. Explain to your kids why you could only see them every other weekend.
You know...
I mean...
There is someone I know over there. Let me see if I can do some work.
Just see if he's even in the studio.
I'm not going to
see Dom is on the
I'm
line.
Not
going to
text
Dom,
him now, but I
hold on.
I
we got a pre-staged phone call. Hold on.
Back in Linda, because you know how hard it is to give up your child as a mother. Society says girls are supposed to be with their mothers, boys are supposed to be with their fathers. But if you don't have
and these poor radio people think that this is real good radio, like this poor guy. Poor dude has no idea what's really good and what's not. This is his favorite show, and he's calling in like an idiot.
Have it in you. The kid's going to suffer, and so you at least are keeping the kid from suffering.
Right, and divorce is already hard enough.
Oh, yeah.
You don't need that extra pressure to put on a child, because children always think they're responsible for it.
No, absolutely. I agree with you, man. I do appreciate that.
My kids just worry about how much I'd be drinking on the weekend.
Yes, Anissa.
How you doing?
Good, how are you? First-time caller.
Hey, first-time caller. Welcome to the Freak Show. What do you think?
Wow. Tookie. Mason calls once he tookies. He wants his tookie back.
Well, boosting and I brought right in the Niels and Watermark's on the stream.
Yeah. What?
Probably giving the ratings boost right now because the Nielsen Watermark's on the stream.
Oh, man. So, okay. Ooh, great. That'll show them. Tell Woody not to chill out on this today that we're going to be a little bit down because I'm giving my credit over to him, but it'll just show you how Macho Man, it would be interesting to see the bump, right? Absolutely. Do this more often.
Anissa didn't do it.
I know she did it. I'm just like, you know, I understand where you come from.
This is great radio.
I could never do it with my child.
Yeah,
but you
No, everyone's different.
Yeah, true. I mean, you know what? That's I think it's kind of unfair. I mean, I'm not sticking up for it, but I thank you in this.
Man, it sounds like awful happy for him.
It's unfair for everybody just to assume because you're a mom, you got it in you.
Mm-hmm.
Like, that's like saying every dad got it in him. Every dad doesn't have it in him.
No, not at all.
But when a dad...
Especially when you're drinking and getting a DUI on a Saturday. What kind of dad's that?
Yeah, he's a dad. You know how them dudes are.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But it's like a woman leaves it. It's like, oh, well, how could she ever?
Yeah, Bonnie from Tampa also agrees. She says, this is another one of those stigmas. A mom is no less a mom because she has shared custody.
But by the way, I think Orlando has full custody of his daughters.
You sure?
So that means I do. I think he has full custody of his daughters. So maybe that means the mom's not even involved. I don't know. That's just what I've heard. I don't know that to be true.
It said online they were co-parenting. Yeah.
So, you know.
I like that she owned up.
Oh, they're co-parenting.
That she
that's what it said right. online, but who
okay,
knows?
Good.
And as much, but now all that energy when she does have.
That means he's got his kids 50% of the time. And, you know, probably getting a DUI, right. It's not going to be look good for them.
Or love, and probably is better doing the part-time.
It's not cool when you can't drive for a year.
Mm-mm. Yeah.
And I don't know that hardship is necessarily, you know, taking your kids out to dinner.
It's not.
Welcome to the Freak Show.
I heard a lot for the simple fact that, I've never been married. I've been a single mom of three for... since my kids have been born.
Man, you're a real hoe. You got three different baby daddies.
It's hard.
That's what I would have come back with.
Certain females should.
I've never been married and I got three kids.
Well, maybe it's all by the same guy.
No.
But not everybody?
Anything wrong. I mean, I don't think everybody could be a parent because my boyfriend has it in him for being a great and wonderful father and taking care of. I don't think he needs a female. You know what I'm saying? Where females all...
It sounds like a bunch of stupid white trash problems to me. I don't think my daddy's got it in to be a daddy. I think my stepdaddy's got it in to be a daddy. Oh, I don't think there's some women should have got it in to be a mama. No, welcome to life. God, parenting.
All right, well, I do appreciate it, Nancy.
Let's talk about your DUI on Saturday, how you refused to blow, and now you're not going to have a driver's license for a year. Let's talk about that.
Hours, and she doesn't have time.
Yeah. And that might be how she's able to fund it. She's like, I'm paying. Like, she's probably paying support.
Yeah.
Because she's got a job, she's committed to that or whatever. I mean, listen, it's hard to judge because we all have life roles, gender roles we try and put on everybody. And really,
drinking roles.
The way for this kid to be happy, that's got to be the headline.
Yeah, this one says.
No, the headlines were Saturday night, Tampa DJ arrested for DUI. Caught vehicular caused, damage. The only thing that we saw.
All right, it's time to get you at $750. Meredith made a list of questions.
Oh,
can you take
another game?
Now we're doing like a Who Wants to Be a Millionaire stuff. Right. Yeah.
Big Birthday Bash is coming to Amalie Arena September 1st, and tickets are...
Oh, they had to tease that. That's what's coming up next is the Zoinksville game.
The next game is
got, and they'll probably come back with a record. Right on, they're going to go through
but
their entire stop
station.
Set.
Like, not that I'm defending them, but like, you can't compare them to us. We're just different.
No, different market. But what I'm saying is,
he
Anna,
compares himself to
within
us.
within his world
yeah.
of having so much time to call in. I'm sorry, so much time to talk, and it seems like your personality is built around these talking crutch points, whether it's a game. Whether it's a confession segment,
mm-hmm.
Why don't you be real? Be real. And everybody in your audience saw the Channel 8 story. Everybody in your audience knows what happened to you on Saturday night. Everybody does. Everybody knows. And so why don't you be a man and be real and not have a fake show, but be real. And answer to what happened, answer to the fans, to your listeners, the people that, listen to your show every day, that really you're their favorite show, they want to know what happened.
The show isn't supposed to be real. I've heard like Holly and Miguel talk about this when they were on the air. The show is supposed to offer escapism. Like, wow, these people have like this perfect life and just like this kind of mindless thing you listen to while you're going to work. You know their lives aren't perfect, but you just kind of like listening to their fake little stories and, oh, I went on this date and, oh, I did this and, oh, I spent time with my kid. Everything's so
amazing.
Kind
of like the Barbie movie.
Exactly.
That's
it's
what
not
radio,
supposed to be real.
Radio
people
has
tune
become
in.
The Barbie movie of entertainment.
Well, not all radio, but that radio, certainly, that's what it's supposed to do, is just be an escape from your life and, like, the real-world problems. They're not talking about Ukraine. They're not talking about Ron DeSantis. They're just talking about stuff that's going on in the community and, you know, stuff like that. So
I just want
for 3 years, zero interest.
I wish we could call in and say, Orlando, buddy.
Let me see if I can reach
out.
First of all,
are you there? Is this a best of?
I do not.
Is this a show that you guys whipped up a little bit yesterday? Maybe everybody was, you know, because I mean, we could do that, right? I mean, you could very, very well have the technology where Orlando gets a hold of everybody on Sunday after he finally got out and said, "Hey, let's all meet at the station, you know, Sunday at 4 o'clock and whip together a best of show." So we can not have to be there. Lummy, it's not. I'm clicking on it, but never mind.
If I went to that one,
I found it.
It looks like Mondays they always play Confessions. Then this is Plead the Fifth. This is one they did last week, and
this is what they do.
Yeah.
Oh, let me plead the fifth. Did you lose your driver's license for a whole year? Plead the fifth.
This is his one from last week.
Advent Health gives you convenient access to emergency care for children and adults. From stopping a heart attack in its tracks to treating a stroke at the first sign.
There you go. Sorry. It's okay. So this is Orlando.
Yeah, they do Monday. Plead the Fifth on Monday.
And how many views does he have on this?
177. Not thousands.
So this is
177.
Hold on. What, how many?
177.
Like 17 more than a 100. 77 more than 100.
Yes.
And this is one of his big segments during his show. And he can only get 177 views.
Yes.
Doesn't that show you the digital world you have not established? That your radio show cannot even garner up a major, major segment that's heard terrestrially. You don't have more than 177 people that heard it live as it happened that wanted to go see it.
Yeah.
Like you, wow.
Realize you were in the wrong.
Ooh.
What?
That happens sometimes.
There's a time where, you know, you got into it with your daughters, you disciplined them, or you got mad at them, and then later on you realize you were in the wrong.
Let's see. There have been a couple of.
And again, this isn't organically. He's playing it up like he knows what he's going to say. They've already talked about it, right? Like you don't pontificate like that.
Times that I was like, I had it wrong. I remember she was supposed to
when you're lying, you're grasping.
And he sucks.
Right.
And with the Lysol and the paper towels in the background, it's like we're in a toilet.
With their dog, they were having like an issue with picking up after their dog.
Mm.
And
you're right, Bubba, about the other one.
Yes, I am so right about her.
Yeah.
Hold on.
Yeah. Mm.
Her,
they did the worst picture ever of her.
They used the worst picture because they got the best one of him.
Right.
But she's actually an attractive and pretty cool person. I know her.
And
that is so annoying. They always promise they're going to clean up and all this stuff.
Like, if I could ever hire her, phew.
Do you know how old she is?
She may be on the market.
I would hire her in a minute.
Hey.
Oh, sorry, Anna.
It's okay. How old is she? Do you know?
But we probably would replace it. Like if I had to get rid of Anna because Meredith was available, I mean, what do you think?
That'd be great for you.
Or do we just add her to you?
Yeah, add her to her.
Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah.
That's a great idea.
What if I came to you and I said, Anna, here's your options.
You gotta get a boob job or I'm hiring Meredith.
Nope. Nope, it's far worse than that.
Okay.
I could care less about your little raisins, okay?
Yeah.
Your raisins bring good content to the yard, okay?
Thank you.
Oh, you liked that, didn't you?
I did.
My raisins bring good content to the yard. But so you're not here or not here because of your raisins. Your raisins have nothing to do with you being with or not with the show.
Okay.
You're okay? I love your little raisins. Your raisins are fine.
Even though you try to persuade me to turn them into Knox.
I could care less. I could care less that you're not smart enough to realize what the hell they would do for you in life.
I'm so dumb.
I know. Like, I mean, no, I mean, like, even Dan's like saying, that bitch has no idea what a new set
no
of, I mean,
idea.
What,
yeah.
like,
so
what a,
dumb.
She's being so dumb because the bitch is cool now.
Idiot.
She's got swagger now.
So dumb.
She's cute now, and people like her now. But if she had some 295s on, pumping those up to a small C, man, her life would change, and she doesn't even know it. So anyway, Anna, that being said, if I came to you and I said, hey, Meredith is available, I'd like to bring her in on the show.
Yeah.
It's either that or, like, you're gone. Like, I'm just, like, saying, I'm bringing her in. I hope that you're not, like, you know, mad about. Like I'm bringing her in. If you have a problem with it, then, you know, sorry, but you got to go. What if I said that?
Oh, bring her on.
No, but could
I'll sabotage it somehow.
Do you think do you think you two could
work together?
Do you think as a show, knowing all the show.
Yeah.
Do you think we could pull it off if we had a hot, you know, snipey chick in here with this current dynamic? Do you think do you think we could make it work?
Of course.
Yeah, I'm trying to think about the elements here, but yeah, I think so.
And would you two be, like, would you guys be friends? Would you guys would be ganging up on us? Or would you guys, like,
know.
Be enemies?
I don't know.
Would you guys get bitchy with each other, you think?
Of course, at the beginning
see,
they would.
But wouldn't that be so
vaginas,
cool?
They couldn't help it.
But wouldn't that be great radio if we had two chicks that were bitchy at each other all the time? And we just sat back and watched them bitch at each other?
Yeah, as opposed
you know
to
how women
I'm
are,
a mommy fighter.
Because so, you know how women are. They're so cynical. And Anna would just cut to the bone with her insults. And just, you know, oh.
No, that's low hanging fruit. You gotta pump her up, even if you hate her.
Okay. Take the care of the dog, and then usually
and,
it doesn't
and it was
happen.
Like, you know, going out to walk the dog, and my neighbor saw him like out without one of the towels.
Oh, so hold on, I gotta get out of here. This is I'm punishing you at this point.
Not really. That was actually the best part of the morning.
What I'm saying is like,
your
man, you're gonna.
Highlight.
I mean, just you know what, dear Orlando, just keep the camera on Meredith the entire time,
right?
And you guys can you can continue to host the show and. And get, you know, whatever, you can run the show. It's still your show,
right.
But don't show your ass. Do not show you. You're hideous. And then that other little cheesy young dude that you got with this little Chester the mole is as tis or
mustache.
Yeah, with his little Cheeto Bandito mustache, trying to be
D-broom.
A dark match. You know, a Nick Cannon.
He's new. He's a new guy. I think he's only been there like 10
What's
days.
What's his name?
His name's. I'm trying to be Nick Cannon. That's what his name is. So just if you guys just put Meredith on there, and you guys do the talking.
Meredith like, in the morning.
I've told you how to. I've told no. Don't even rename it. Just put the camera on her.
Okay.
And those jugs.
Right.
That's
Chalks.
It.
They'll get more than 177 views.
Yeah.
Right.
Absolutely.
Hey,
hold on. I was trying to listen live again.
I want
see
you to
what,
call
does,
Gary.
Does, man, Gary. We know Gary too. Dan,
great guy. Very aggressive advertising.
We might need to blow a call in.
Yeah, very aggressive.
See if we can get some of that advertising dollars.
Use some of that money to pay Meredith.
I like the song.
That's another song. Is that
it's Rihanna and Drake?
Is that more music in the morning?
I believe so.
Oh.
I bet you she'd be like so much more fun, you know, if she could talk more.
Oh man, if she could be with us.
Yeah.
And
just
if
imagine.
She could be with, hey, I'm just gonna go ahead and put an offer out there, okay? Let me write this down on the notes.
I
on the notes. This is official. I'm going into words with this, but you know, and you guys might want to make this a short as well.
Put out to her.
Hey, Meredith, co-host of the Orlando 94.1 morning show, formerly before that with MJ. I've known you for a while. We never were really close. I think we only met a couple different times, but we are both super cool. I think that you are an amazing radio talent.
Amazing.
I've always
that she's a great mom too. She likes that.
Is she your mom?
Anna,
yeah.
Don't try to commandeer my message to Meredith. You're already trying to get in on this and make it bad.
Saboteur.
You're trying to sabotage this message. No, she's going
to
hear this message.
I don't want her to come over here.
During my offer, you need to shut up, okay?
Right.
We know how you feel about it. We know you're intimidated by her, and we know you don't want her here, but she is amazing, and she's just probably what the show needs.
You're probably right.
Another female that's a little bit bitchy that didn't put up with any of your stuff, who's super hot. And right. she's a mom, too, so she can be like, all right, whatever, you can think about all that, but I'm a mom. I got a kid. I raised a kid, too. I got two kids.
Two kids? She married?
Yeah, I think so, yes.
I heard that maybe she might have been not married. They might be divorced.
You might be right, but I know she has two girls.
If she's divorced, man.
They're very cute.
Listen, us hiring you, Meredith, has nothing to do with whether you're married or not, but you can be a little bit more flirtatious if you were not married. You know what I'm saying?
I prefer it.
The fans would really, really, really like it. No, not flirtatious to me. Well, yeah, sure. We'd like to flirt with her a little bit, wouldn't we, Dan? Sure.
Game on.
So, Meredith, listen, if you ever get in a situation where you want to leave that place, you're not happy there, and you like to come jump onto, you know, the show, and at that point, we'll give you your own, just like, it'll be just like the Anna template.
Yeah.
You're, mm-hmm. you're a female co-host.
Get a t-shirt.
And then, yeah, sure, we'll have Meredith merch, sure. Once she becomes
all tank tops.
Well, yeah, and once she becomes more popular than Otto, which won't take long,
right?
And then she'll get her own merchandise, just like everybody does. Dan, I'm going to treat her just like Anna. She's going to be on the show.
Just to design a hat.
She's going to be on the show, and then I'd like for her to do one, you know, Meredith show. You know, like maybe Thursdays after show could be the Meredith show. So Anna's current, you know, responsibilities for the show is maybe she could help you with Instagram, too. She might be really.
I heard she makes a mean mac and cheese.
Yeah.
I listen sometimes.
So there you go.
I like her.
I like her. And dear Meredith, you need to somehow get a hold of me. I don't know who would have my number, or I need to get just somehow.
I know someone.
Get me her number. And I'm going to listen, Meredith, if you don't want me to text you, then when I do text you. Say, Bubba, do not text me. I'm not interested in any way, shape, or form. I heard what you said on the radio. Do not text me. And I will not text you. Like, I'm not some weirdo.
But I may.
But Dr. Dan, you might get some D-picks from Dan. And you know what? I will tell you this, Meredith, being a woman, you know, you probably, you know, Dan throw in some Botox. Some, you know, all the skin stuff.
Those little perks you don't really see on your contract.
Right. All the plastic surgery perks. Mm-hmm. I mean, most of that will be covered for free if you're as good as we think you are.
And smart.
Better health insurance.
With Allstate.
We don't have health insurance here.
Well, we got Botox.
What was the
Hey, hold on. No health insurance, but we got Botox and the Morpheus.
Or right. a small snack.
They're already playing commercials. You sent me their what, Lummy?
Her Instagram.
Oh, yeah. So hold on.
What do you think she gets paid now?
I don't know. Let's not get into that, okay?
Probably like 60, 70.
No way.
You don't think so?
No. Do you want me to be honest? I don't want to embarrass her. I mean, I don't want to embarrass her.
I mean, I'm talking about after endorsements and everything.
I'm telling you, she probably makes 45.
Oh, we could match that between you and me and everything else.
Steve and everybody, right?
Right, yeah. Because she could do some promotions for the office.
She's savvy. Dan, let's not throw out numbers on what we're offering.
Okay.
If she's interested, we'll talk to her about a compensation package.
Compensation.
See that's the way
it's a package.
Meredith,
we'll show
if
you the
you're
package.
Interested, now Meredith, do some research and research the show and how many different places were heard.
But don't Google me.
And you know, see how big, you know, look at our digital presence, look at our YouTube presence, look at our Twitter, Facebook, Instagram. I mean, you know, we got a pretty huge digital platform. That's where the industry is headed. I don't know if you really can do. I mean, Anna, you'll be the, not that you want her here, but if you were to be honest, intellectually honest as a female,
yeah.
If you were just to be intellectually honest as a female to Meredith, and you know what she gets to do now, you know, she's the co-host on, you know, like a Hot 105 show where they have these little setup bits and they talk very short form and you know exactly what it is. And you know how much different and free and transparent and wild and just the complete opposite of what she has to do now is you can hear is completely opposite because you can be and say anything you want pretty much.
Yeah, it's a completely different art form.
Yeah, I mean, like, you.
I could never do what she does. like, what's up? Like, I can't do that.
The predetermined fake stuff. The canned.
I just sound like a sarcastic bitch the whole time because I can't sound enthusiastic when I'm actually
not. You can't sound real.
Yeah, exactly.
The campy, you know, corporate top four. You know, there we go. The campy corporate standard template, you know, pop culture popular show,
yeah,
right?
And I'm not knocking what she's doing, but it's just, it's a completely different skill set, one that I don't have.
Well, no, you're developing.
Well, I mean, what she's doing, I'm not working on that.
Oh, no,
which
no.
Just different.
Meaning you couldn't do what she does.
No, right. I can't interview like celebrities and pop stars and stuff.
How liberating would it be for her? Because everybody gets into radio. Not everybody gets into radio so that you can just, you know, shuttle records at songs and do little 20-second speed breaks. That's not why people get into radio. People don't get into radio to do 20-second speed breaks. People get into radio to inevitably do what we do. Long-form monologue.
You think that's everyone's goal?
Yeah, I do. Or, I mean, you know, that'd be like saying I want to be in the NFL, but love me, I only want to be a long snapper or a punter.
Yeah, no one dreams of that.
Even the long snapper and the punter would wish
Casey
he could.
Casey Kasem wasn't doing long form, and he was making a lot of money.
Yeah, but there's over the years on. And how many? Okay, and how many are those?
Very few, but there's very few of everything
so you got
that are really
millions
successful.
And millions of midday people, and millions and millions of night people, and millions of top 40 radio people that at the end of the day don't want to talk for 8 seconds. They want to talk long form, transparent. They want to talk about, hi, it's Jim. And I got the gym show going on. I'm super popular. I'm making a lot of money. I got my own studios. And let me tell you about my poop this morning. Man, I had corn in my poop this morning, and I blasted my wife 3 times this weekend. And this is, people want to be able to think that their lives and the things that they experience in life would be, you know, popular enough to garner an audience that you could make a living off of.
Sure.
Not at, how
it's,
many?
It's more risky what we do, though, because when you open yourself up to talk about things that really matter, you know, you invite a lot more people to hate you. And I don't think that they're in the market of being controversial.
She would have to realize that, you know, being on the show, she's going to get that much more attention. And there'd be some people. I don't really see anything wrong with her Instagram, Anna. Or Lummi, I don't see how you can
great.
Pick. I don't think how you
I certainly
pick,
don't look like that in a bathing suit.
I don't
so.
Think you can pick
God
any of that
her.
Apart. So I think the Bubba Army would be like, wow, yeah, oh, yeah, you know, yeah. Like, you know, whatever.
Doctor approve you.
But I think that she would love it over here. And, you know, when she was with the MJ show, they talked to MJ started, you know, when MJ was going at his heyday at FLZ, he was doing. He was only playing about 2 or 3 songs an hour. So he was doing very long form. And that's when she thrived and did her best.
Right. And she's the most interesting thing on his show.
Well, yeah. And she's the most interesting thing on Orlando's show.
Right.
So if we get her to come on a real show that already has interest, then what happens?
She becomes interesting and he just wilts away.
Well, I could care less. I could really care less what happens to him. But she certainly adds to us. She makes us better, I think. She gives us a different dynamic. And we have 2 chicks instead of 1 now. What's better than that?
3.
Well, we're not going to go. I mean, at that point,
get ahead of yourself,
Dan, at that point, Dan, I got to start replacing people. If we were, even when we wire Meredith in, we're going to have to like put her over there, like build, we're going to have to build something special for her, you know, when you're here, or, you know, do something. We're going to have to add another mic position. Maybe up here by me, maybe we'd put...
Yeah, Dan's looking right around. He sees some space around him. Yeah.
See, here's the deal. But we're going to have to separate
why?
Anna and Meredith. They can't stand... They can't be side by side.
Put me between them. You could put me between them.
No,
have a little sandwich.
We'll put Meredith up here, Dan.
Okay. Closer to you?
No, not... Yeah.
Right here on my lap.
No, not on my lap. But, I mean, I've already talked to Macho Man about making this spot right here beside me.
To the right of you?
Right where the band board is.
Right.
To making that a guest spot for when we had guests.
Mm-hmm.
They were this much closer to me because now we're visual.
Mm-hmm.
And
be able to make eye contact with them, or is your screen covering them?
No, I would absolutely be able to make eye contact with them.
Okay.
Because I interview differently. You know, I just not being, right. You know, I mean.
I understand.
So, yeah, we'll put her there, of course, wouldn't you?
Right.
And she's hot as hell. I want to look at her knockers when we're live on the air.
Right.
I might even have her face in me and be like, hey, Meredith, can you wear a tank top every show?
No screen.
Anna's going to be so mad when we hire Meredith.
I know. That's right.
And then Anna, like, hopefully
we still love you.
Hopefully,
Anna.
Yeah, Anna.
We still love you. You're the OG.
In fact,
you're
Anna,
like, you're like the mama. Anna. Mama Anna.
Anna, you know what, though?
Mama Anna?
Hold on. Yeah. Hold on. Anna, it might.
She'll be like
Anna,
the young fresh.
Might, it might help your popularity. It might help your popularity.
Yeah, I'm sure it will. You're a genius.
No, I'm just saying, like, it I mean, because everybody pulls for the underdog.
Right.
Do
all
they?
Of a sudden.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm the underdog. They're pulling for me. Now you're dancing with me, baby. And we got the hot ones, Dan and Meredith over there, all full of themselves and all. Yeah. But you and I are the backbone.
All goes. Yeah, great.
Hey, me and Lummy and you can be the ugly ducklings of the rat. God, rat.
That's why he's not even on camera.
Yeah, that's why Red's. Hold on. You can't keep patching up your pain, taking shots at the
ball. Know exactly how you feel. I know what's in your seems like a tremendous waste of her talent to just sit there and not
Meredith,
say anything.
Dear Meredith, what are you doing when. I mean, you could be on the air here being hot, sounding cool.
Yeah.
Looking good. There you go. That's officially what we offer. What I say, looking good, sounding hot, having fun.
Yep.
Being
there you
cool.
go. Being cool, looking good, having, I mean, like being able to talk for, I mean, literally, Meredith, we can talk for as long as we want.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have our own shows thereafter where you, I mean, Meredith, have you ever had your own show?
Free Botox.
Well, I think she does now, but I think they play music on it.
Yeah, but still, you can't be Meredith. People want Meredith. People want you. What you're really all about. Are you a freak? Are you conservative? Like, you know, we get all into all of that. I'm sure they don't get into that in this show. I mean, Orlando can't be like, hey, Meredith, seriously, you ever jet skied before?
Mm.
She'd be like, don't say that. He's like, no, come on, just be honest. I mean, we're just, you know, I pooped. I did a thing on Madeira Beach one time where I got poopy D. It was so
now you're chasing her off.
No, I'm just saying, like, you know, just... Yeah, I'm not being creepy. You're right.
Not everyone loves poopy D like I do, Bubba.
What's that?
Not everyone loves poopy D like I do.
I know.
I think it's so funny.
No Madeira Beach.
See, Anna has a role.
Her birthday this morning, riding out with us in Tampa. Come on, man. Celebrate. Let's turn up.
So, that's it?
Yeah, they're that's turning it. Up at 7:39 a.m. Yeah, this is pre-recorded.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Good stuff.
So, but see that was be why she would be so good for the show, Dan, because she would be like, "Don't tell me the Madeira Beach story." And Anna's like, "Oh my God, Daddy, tell me the Bill or tell the Madeira."
It's one of my campfire stories.
It's my favorite story ever. And Meredith would be like, "Don't tell that story." You know, like so, like that. Dan, it's good for the show. You got one that wants it,
right?
You know, one that doesn't,
right?
And so probably
really the one that wants it doesn't really want it. The one that doesn't want it really wants it.
Dan, I'm not getting into the. You're getting into
not
the
cycle. Not to derail this whole thing, but don't you think they're just going to blow him out?
What?
Not to derail this whole idea, but don't you think they'll just blow him out, save the money, and make her primary host?
Oh, they should.
That's what's going to happen. That's a corporate way.
Macho, thanks. Appreciate it. For really, really, really. Now, they may have never thought about that. Now they're going to think about it.
Way to go, Macho.
And
you
screwed us. Way to go, Macho.
Thank you. Thought about it.
Oh, way to go, Macho.
Thanks, Macho.
No, but now she's not available.
There's
she's the main
no
chick.
Way she would host that show. You
Why
think
not?
They're gonna have a white chick hosting on
the
an urban station? No, that's not a good look.
Right.
It's a great look when you're
not a good color. Look.
Hold on, it's a great look when you look like her.
Yeah.
You can tell me, Ty.
I'm telling you, they would never do that.
Won't go over. They won't tolerate it.
Yeah.
The listeners, the American community.
The listeners won't tolerate her being the host.
They should.
No way.
Ty J would tolerate.
Shouldn't have to cry.
The Bubba the Love Sponge show returns after these words.
Lummy, I have all types of emotions that are running through my little peanut gorilla head as I have our next guest that is today a guest. Used to be a regular, and today he's just a guest. At best on my program.
Yeah,
used to
sad.
Be a show regular. I would even call it a show weekly contributor. And now he is just a guest until he apologizes to me for so rudely disrespecting one of his, me, Bubba. Hello, Alex. How you doing?
Well, first of all, I you owe me an apology, Bubba, because what just happened this past weekend, I have no support system. I'm out there on a professional boxing match. I have my professional license. They are gassing me up like a jumbo jet headed to the World Trade Center. They're gassing me up so much. I'm talking about full of gas. They said, Alex, you're going to be the next influencer boxing. The way you cut promos, Alex, with some of the people for part of that promotion said, you cut a promo better than a professional wrestler. They were sucking it. They had knee pads on, right? Oh, Alex, the way you cuss him out, the way you get in his face, that was so good. Then we get to the press conference Thursday morning. I say, hey, to his corner man, to my corner man, hey, I'm going to throw hot dogs. They are turkey dogs. I'm going to say they're pork. That's the work, that they're pork, but they're really turkey dogs. I don't want to be disrespectful to his Islamic faith.
I got to dump. Yes, I dumped it. So, we didn't get canceled by Alex Stein. Go ahead.
Sorry. So my promotion says it's okay. Happy Punch promotion run by Keemstar. They think it's so funny.
Right.
During the press conference.
And hold on now. Here's the thing I didn't know. Here's the thing that nobody's reporting, and I'm glad I got my friend back. Can you at least just say you're sorry over the Shuley deal? Can you say sorry?
I'm sorry about the Shuley deal. I don't know why you got so butthurt about it. I had to reschedule.
It's over.
I mean, what are we, two girls going to sit here and lie and bitch and moan about this?
You said you were sorry. We're moving on, bitch. About to get mine.
Yeah, but I'm not sorry anymore because you screwed me because I had no support system. I had nobody, hey, should I run this bit by? Should I do? I had nobody in my ear saying, hey, maybe don't throw hot dogs. Maybe don't screw yourself out of $15,000.
Hold on. I would have been the first one to say, Alex, if you've cleared it with both promotions, that is going to be one hell of a high spot. I would have been the first one to say that.
I know, but so listen, the promotion liked it that I was boxing under, but a bigger promotion, Wasserman Boxing, the one that gets us our license, the actual legitimate professional promotion that actually hires the cable company DAZN that films it. This is a top dog. Supposedly, they have some important, influential Saudi Arabian people, a part of that company, and they did not take very kindly to the stunt that I did. And I screwed myself because, Bubba, there's a fight in October. They were saying, oh, you're going to be on the October card. Alex, if you win this fight, you're going to be the next in influencer boxing. You're 6'3". You can be the next influencer boxing heavyweight.
You probably could. I mean, especially.
I know.
I mean, you're not good because, we were watching your training and it was horrible. But, I mean, everybody's got to start somewhere. And, you know, if you could have knocked this guy out and just got one under your belt, then got some real training for your next one, and you get lucky on that one. I mean, you could have been really making some pretty big money because you can cut a promo. You know how to work. You know how to get heat. You know how to reverse the heat. You're brilliant at it. I can't play the sound, but I can play the incident right now, Lummy. Okay, yes. I'm gonna play, but I can't play the sound. I can only and Alex isn't gonna be able to watch it. But this is what happened. Alex is on the microphone, and he's got like what looks to be like an ice bucket. Is it literally the hotel's ice bucket?
Holiday Inn Express ice bucket. Right. Yes, sir. You nailed that.
Full of turkey dogs. Turkey,
yes, sir.
Turkey hot dogs.
100% meat turkey. No
and
pork.
He What's already right? had it cleared with the opposition that he, because the opposition's a Muslim. And pork is just like
haram.
Like, it's just
they call it haram.
It's yes, very, it's very right. disrespectful. It's like you just don't do it. And so, Alex assured the corner, the other people, they're turkey dogs, but act like they're hot dogs. It'll blow the spot up. It'll be just huge. Again, it's knowing how to work, right? And he was the guy who was going to probably come unglued, almost get you, try to whip your ass. It was a big whodunit, and for the build up for the fight, right?
100% spot on.
So here we go. Alex has the hot dogs. He now throws the hot dogs onto the Muslim man. The Muslim man jumps onto the stage and starts going for Alex, trying to kill Alex. The Muslim man that Alex is going to fight is kicking over tables now, being held back like a wild man. Alex is still sitting there with his little jacket on, probably just stirring up the crap, calling him. I mean, I'm sure you're calling him all kinds of names and stuff at this point, and they have to restrain the guy that's supposed to be Alex Jones, Alex Stein's opponent, and they have to, separate you two, and boom. And had the promotion that's in charge of the promotion, who has some Muslim Saudi Arabian men that are were highly offended because they bought the bit. They bought it hook, line. I mean, the bit was so believable. The high spot was so believable that even the owners bit on the deal.
And the Sun News, which is the kind of the whatever, like rag in the UK. I don't even know, like National Enquirer, but the UK. They immediately wrote an article about it. They called me for comment. I told them, hey, it was a turkey dog. It was a total work. Still, when that article came out, and then it became an international story, Daily Mail, all the sports sites.
Oh, yeah, everybody carried it. So when they're the equivalent to their USA Today or equivalent to their big newspaper called you, you laid it all out, said, hey, it was a work, it was turkey dogs, I had it pre-approved, and even after you said that, they still squashed you?
They still squashed me, and I showed them the turkey dog packaging. I showed them a video. And this is the same card that let Greg Hardy fight on it. Yeah, Greg Hardy was arrested for domestic violence. There's other fighters on there that had said some abhorrent stuff about Muhammad in some tweets, you know, comparing him to, like, Jeffrey Epstein.
Oh, man.
I would never say that.
No
I would
way.
Never disrespect Muhammad
you,
like that.
You
no.
know. You know better.
Yeah, and I wasn't even trying to disrespect his faith. If I was, I would have thrown, because this is the thing. Originally, somebody said, hey, why don't you go get bacon from where it's staying at the Holiday Inn Express in Nashville. It's actually a pretty nice Holiday Inn Express, but they had a lovely breakfast bar, buffet.
You were going to get you like 8 or 9 pieces of bacon and throw bacon
and
on
I
them.
Said, no. They brought me the bacon. I said, no, I'm not going to throw actual bacon on them, because then I don't have an out.
Now I really am. I don't have an out. With here, I got it's a high spot gimmick that the average person won't know. But the inner circle will know. It'll be a huge heat getter, and it'll make for a it would be a great fight. It causes all the rage. If he knocks you out, it's a talking point for him. If you knock him out, it's a talking point for you. It just, oh my God, it writes itself.
Well, this is what's so stupid, is that they took away a fight from him, a Muslim guy that should have been able to knock my head off after, because Mo was in on it. Mo wants to fight. So now we're working out. We're going to try to do the card in 60 days under Happy Punch Promotion back in Nashville, since we're both licensed there. So we're still going to do it. I went from being on the prelim to where I'll be the headliner of my next fight. But it just doesn't have the same cachet, because I wanted to work for Wasserman, the company that fired me. They're the biggest and baddest. If I would have been in with them,
so you're saying you're gonna have to go do it with a lesser promotion, and
the smaller promotion that was under our card, so it's not gonna have the same pay. I mean, we can do a gimmick pay per view, we can film and stream it, but it's just not gonna. It's not the same as this company called The Zone. Which
no,
is
you gotta be
company.
You gotta be with the promotion in itself. You can't be a one off.
Well, what we're going to do is, it's called Canceled Clash, where there's a couple other fighters. There's another fighter that got canceled from a similar boxing event. So we're going to be able to do a gimmick thing. And if I win that, I do believe that I could repair my relationship with Wasserman. Maybe not. But
have you talked to the Wasserman people?
No, but I made a video. I went and got in their face in selfie mode and said, you let Greg Hardy fight, you let this fight, and just totally put
that,
him, you know.
That may not have been the
Well, I haven't posted it yet. They asked me not to post it.
Why don't you baby instead of heel right now? Listen to your great sensei. Why don't you baby instead of heel and get a hold of Wasserman or whatever the hell it is and say, listen, we all know that those were turkey dogs. I did what I thought I needed to do. I even got a hold of the guy, the Muslim man I was fighting. His corner knew. You guys knew. That's how much of a showman I am. That's how much heat I bring. I bring borderline right up to the edge heat, but I did it in a respectful, you know, only a few would really know the angle type deal. It would have created a huge deal. And please know that I'm sorry for that. And I'd love to be part of your promotion. Don't bring in the Greg Hardys and all that kind of stuff. They don't want to be reminded that, you know, they don't want that.
I know, and you're right, and I do want to babyface with them, but I have to prove my worth now and draw.
But you just need to reemphasize how the steps that you tried to do, you know, the infrastructure that you laid.
No, but listen to this. I have to cut you off. I even said I would donate my whole entire purse to a Muslim charity that they wanted. I'm saying to get that fight. I said I would have donated my whole entire purse to a charity, and they still wouldn't let me fight.
Man, so, I mean, that's ridiculous.
Yeah, but we're gonna figure it out. But it's still, because it's potentially that's hundreds of thousands of dollars that I left on the table because
that's one of your biggest mess ups ever. That's your Hogan sex tape.
This is one of my biggest sex tape.
Is this your Hogan sex tape? Say it.
No, it's not that big, but it's close.
See, Hogan sex tape ruined me. It just completely ruined me. You know?
Yeah, but what's the deal? So Hogan's married now, and he's going.
I guess he's engaged now to this will be his third wife.
The Scientologist.
Some people are reporting that she is a Scientologist. I've heard that.
I don't know. You need to have this guy Aaron Smith Levin on. He has one of the best anti-Scientology channels. He was a Sea Org member for years.
Yeah, but
left.
Can I tell you something, bud? I live in this community, and there are some people that you really just, you know. Now, listen, if you live in, you know, Dallas, Texas, like you, and you want to go wild on the Scientologists, that's one thing. But when you live in their backyard and they can control things.
But listen, I'm fighting with this guy, Grant Cardone, who's like a fake billionaire. He's kind of one of these like rich guys, invest, get into real estate type guys. And he's one of the biggest Scientologists. And I've called him out and he's here in Dallas. But my point is, these Scientologists are all full of.
Hold on. You ain't got Sea Org in Dallas, bitch.
No, I know. It's not the same. Yeah, it's not the same. We don't have the Sea Org.
I mean, we got Sea Org.
HQ.
We got Xenu. We got Clear Meters. We got it all. You know what we got?
Really,
we got me shutting my fat ass up over this deal. And you're on Scientology on your own, my friend.
Yep.
I don't believe in it. Mm-hmm. I think they're murderers. I think they murdered that Karen woman.
His wife is gone. David Miscavige, Shelley Miscavige. Nobody can find her. Hey, but I'll put Scientology over a little bit. They do get a lot of people off drugs and alcohol. They have, you know, whatever that rehab program. So I think they do some good.
Maybe Orlando can go to their rehab program and get
it's
off.
It's free, I think. I think that's the only free thing.
Did losing that that opportunity hurt your Blaze gig?
I mean, they didn't like it.
Do you ever notice, man, that the common denominator of everything we talk about is how you're on such thin ice at the Blaze? Like, everything's evolved around that. Like, I never have conversations with you to be like, you know what, man, I'm killing it at the Blaze. They hauled me in last week and said, my God, we're so happy with you. You're just, the numbers are great. No, instead, they hauled me in last week and said, man, you're really on thin ice, man. You're getting ready to lose your show at any moment.
Well, let's go over what I've gone viral for. The biggest story is the Brittany Griner confrontation. That was a huge viral story, but that's not necessarily great for them. It's not necessarily great, all the clicks Blaze gets for me, you know, bum rushing Brittany Griner. Then the video I did before that got tens of millions of views. I'm in a tuck friendly bathing suit.
Yeah, but hold on now, man. You know, the Brittany Griner deal, man, that was not like, I mean, some of the things I would be like, I don't think you did anything wrong there at all.
Yeah,
I mean,
that wasn't that bad, but I'm just saying,
I think most of America was kind of rallying behind you there a little bit.
Yeah, but the mainstream media, Blaze personality, right wing. I mean, if you just read some of the articles.
And then the San Francisco, that was kind of cool. The San Francisco high spot, that was kind of cool.
I had some high spots this year. I've had some viral stories. I'm talking about international stories, but, you know, it's just, they're for edgy stuff. For me,
now,
hot dogs on an Islamic
one,
person.
Which one has made you the most money? Or do they instantaneously get demonetized?
The Griner one, I mean, I did really well on that.
Yeah, they couldn't demonetize you because you're just asking questions with a person.
Well, they gave a strike for one of the interviews. They said I sexualized her, so I ended up getting a strike. So it's like, yeah, I got a bunch of new followers.
You're actually on two strikes right now, aren't you?
I'm on one strike on two different channels. So, yeah.
<He's crazy. laughs> You're such a dick, man. You just can't let it go, can you, Cub?
No, because I got a mental health issue. I need to go like Howard Stern and go to a psychiatrist 5 times a week, but then they'd probably convince me that I'm a woman and to get on gender hormone therapy. So that's why I don't really trust
that would be all right.
Are you still
yeah,
a pay-per-view?
For you, Bubba, you would love it if I put on a dress and prance around, but you know, I'm done with a dress, so I'm detransitioning.
How about pay-per-view? Where are we?
No, and then I'm all messed up. My ex, I can't stop thinking about her. I miss her.
Yeah.
So I mean, I was telling
you all along how special she was, and you're gonna lose. Loser, and you're like, oh yeah, what? I'm a rock star. That bitch is gone. She's gone. Just like Hall and Oates. Just like Hall
and
Oates.
And it hurts.
And you know what?
All these
not only is she gone, but she's ghosting you too.
I haven't been hitting her up, but listen, there's all these other ladies in my DMs and stuff, and I don't even want to get with them because it's so hard to build back up that friendship. I don't even want to get back in the dating scene.
It's so hard to learn the Alex Stein idiosyncrasy world. It's just hard to get a girl to understand your whirlwind, if you will. Like, you know, you could
learn each other's weirdness.
Yeah, and like, you know, you could be in Dallas for 2 weeks, but you could literally be on a moment's notice, have to be in Chicago tomorrow, Washington, D.C. on Friday, and then another high spot in Miami on Saturday with a quick end around back to Dallas on Sunday. You get some needy bitch, and she's like, oh, my God, I cannot have you be out of town that long because I miss you. Man, pay-per-view is cool as hell. She understood it. She was hot. She accompanied you to some of the stuff. You blew it, buddy.
I blew it. But then she was just getting so mad and jealous of everything. It was just getting so... It was like every day I felt guilty about something that I didn't even do.
You mean she was getting mad and jealous because you were starting to get a little bit popular and there's some...
No!
Has there been some...
No, she only went out with me.
Has there been some...
She only
some
went out with me because I was popular. No, I got to show you this girl, Bree Teresi, that she hates, who I became friends with.
Oh, is this the new one? Just the new one?
No. This happened
maybe,
months ago. Is that
maybe? Is this the new one? Maybe.
No, I'm not.
Okay, wait. I want to hear about this Bree chick.
Yeah, show me. I'm gonna look this Bree chick up.
This is what. Look at Bree Teresi. She's a guest model. She's a legit model. But this is what started the downfall of our relationship. Is that I met Bree Teresi at this conservative event. She's a really pretty model. Mm-hmm. Just befriended her. And I messaged her, or she messaged me. I forget how we started talking to DMs. It was very harmless.
Mm, sure.
But she
next
said...
Next thing you know, your penis is beside her in her mouth. And
girl, but she's a model. Forget. She has big breasts. She has a tiny waist. You know, just type
isn't
it
that,
in.
Is that the golf model? Is that the golf model?
Yes, it's a golf model. Huh. So she's trying to get into politics, kind of. And I tell her, I noticed when I follow her on Instagram, oh, you have an OnlyFans. I'm like, you know, that's not going to help you out that much. She messaged me like, oh, well, I'm not even naked on my OnlyFans. I cover my nipples. And I was like, I don't know. So she sends me a free trial to her OnlyFans.
Oh,
so, of course,
God.
I accept the free trial.
Well, of course you do, bud.
Just to see if she's telling the truth or not. She's going to be a potential guest. Well, come to find out, prepaid's on my home computer, in the studio computer right now while I'm in Phoenix at this event. First thing that comes up in my email, I leave my email open, Alex Stein, OnlyFans, Bree Teresi. And I'm like, oh, I didn't know this.
Have you sent it to me yet?
Yeah, the Instagram?
No, where'd you send it to me?
Your messenger.
Oh, God.
I'll send it again. Right. Ready?
Yeah.
So I get caught. I get caught having this thing. I'm like, listen, I got it free. I didn't pay for it. But Bree's like, she gives me a break, but she's really mad. Well, about a month later, Bree Teresi, not prepaid, goes viral because she's a lingerie model.
Whoa. Whoa.
Bree's my friend. Yeah. So Bree goes viral she works for a lingerie company and they hired a guy to be model some of their lingerie. So she quit. She publicly quit. She went on Fox News. She went on The Blaze. She did a whole circuit of shows. She says, Alex, I would like to come on your show. I said, yeah, I'd love to have you, Bree, on my show. I tell prepaid, hey, Bree Teresi's coming on my show. Paige says, no. And I listen to Paige, even though I was so butthurt. I'm like, what? Why can't I have her on the show?
Hold on.
I sent you her Instagram.
Hold on. Pay-per-view was trying to tell you can't have a hot chick on as a guest?
She said I couldn't have this girl on, and so that was the start of everything.
F thing.
Yeah, it started,
So pay-per-view knew that you were going to blast her. She knew. I mean, women's tuition, you know?
Well, I mean, this woman comments is a model.
Yeah, exactly.
She's hot.
And she was
Anyone
going
wants
viral.
To blast her.
But honestly, she was going viral. I'm saying she was viral at that point. Like, I had a reason to talk to her. I wasn't just having...
No, and she reached out to you, you know?
Yeah.
And she was going on Blaze shows. She's on other Blaze shows. But so that started off this kind of where I'm like butthurt. So I'm kind of mad at her. And it just started this jealousy thing where it just wasn't... It lost a lot of its fun.
Not really.
Bree's
well,
the homewrecker?
Well, there's other girls that comment on my stuff that I don't even know who they are. Half of them are crazy girls. And so then every girl that would comment now pays.
I'm the biggest pay-per-view fan in the world, but man, I mean, I'm co-signing with you on that, cousin.
So where's Bree Tressy now? You guys blasting yet?
Yeah, I mean, are you guys a thing?
What I mean, Bree and I are still friends. I mean, I could hang out with Bree right now. I'm sure she'd love to go out.
Right. I mean, like if you wanted, if you texted Bree. See you later on this afternoon and said, hey, you want to come over tonight? You know, Netflix and blast.
Well, she's in Miami, but yeah, if I'm in Miami, I said, hey, do you want to meet me at the Delano Hotel? I'm sure she would come.
How old is she? I can't tell if she's like 18 or 40.
I think Bree's 30. I think she's 29 or something.
Now, have you, you know, do you have any, almost, you know, 30. Any experience with that, you know?
What level
with a,
of hotness?
With a woman like that? No, that is, that's that level of hotness, that is, that's you have nice to go level. In there and deliver. That's yeah, what I'm saying. It's like a football game when so you're you sexually. You got to give you, it, leave it all on the bed. You got to really try hard.
You haven't taken that around the farm yet at all.
I have not.
Liar.
Liar.
I haven't.
Wow.
But Bree is a really
now
nice.
I know why you're not so upset. Is. You know, over this pay per view deal. Now I know, like, you know, pay per view shmashmer from you.
Well, if I would have had Jesus. You and pay per view. This fight would have gone different. I would have had people in my corner who would have helped me out, but I didn't. I've been flying solo, and it's hard.
And your Bubba Sensei hasn't been here to talk you off the ledge either. Because I do some.
That's
I do
what I'm
do.
Saying. This is your fault, Bubba, because you were not there to give me guidance. A lot of this cancellation couldn't be levied onto you personally. Yeah. I mean, I'm just doing that for my own personal deal, so I don't take a lot of the responsibility.
Well, listen, just keep your blaze gig. And keep trying to hook up with that chick. That's all I'm telling you.
Okay, well, I'll bring Bree to Tampa. Bree would be great on your show. She's actually really laid back. Yeah, Bree's really.
We're trying to bring another girl her name's. You're familiar with Meredith, right? We're trying to bring Meredith in to compliment Anna. You know.
Yeah. Right.
Who's Meredith? Meredith. Who is it?
You know,
he doesn't know the whole story.
There was a guy in town named Orlando. He's a morning show guy and a program director for the urban station here in town. He got busted for a DUI this weekend, and before the DUI, he was at the client's establishment doing shots of live on Instagram, and ooh. then he heard, you know, he got in a wreck, hurt a guy. And, you know, now the guy's lawyered up and the lawyer wants to, you know, the Instagram account's been deleted. The client is really
Lawyer's got him taking shots and then going and injuring somebody. Oh, yeah. His case is not going to be good.
Well, on his show, he's got this hot blonde named Meredith and she's super good on the radio. She's super hot and she's got a lot of radio experience and she could just slide right on in here. And compliment our female, our already very move, female presence. Just make our female presence that much stronger.
I don't think that's going to help with your female presence. I think that's going to really help with your male presence.
Well, and we're in the male business. What are we, 80-20 male to female?
I think it's 80-20. Right.
Let's make 80% of the fans happy.
Okay.
So...
Well, can we afford her, though, Bubba? I mean, she's probably going to be... I mean, see, the urban stations do pretty good on
we may not be able to afford her, but
book.
That's where Dan steps in and said he would help subsidize her income. Like, he would go in halvesy with me.
Okay, well, actually, I want to talk about this. This is the audience is going to think it's so lame. So, here at the Dallas Sports Station, there's a show called the Hang Zone, and they're owned by Cumulus, and one guy's worked at the station 25 years, the other guy's worked there 17 years, and they didn't re-sign their contract. And then I try to look at the ratings book. The ratings book is so confusing, Bubba.
I don't know if I can get into ratings. Ratings
so hard. No, because I don't understand what you get, like a 5 share, but then your cumulative audience isn't as big as another audience.
Well,
I don't
here's
understand
the deal.
How
you
that wanna, works.
They, you go by day parts and then by demographics. So like sports stations, demographics would be like, you couldn't look at their 12 plus number. You'd want to look at their men 25 to 54 numbers. That's the advertising. That's their target audience, and that's the advertising lane they're trying to sell in. So, you know, where they rate 6 or 12 plus doesn't matter. Where they rate within their target demo is what matters. And they probably were pretty competitive.
Well, and this is my question, is because you'll see the top rated station will get like a 5 share, like a 6 share, but then there'll be other stations that have a higher cumulative audience. So So can you be number one with the cumulative audience and the number one with, I guess, the rated audience?
Yep. It's time spent listening versus cum.
Wow.
How many people? How long? It's a whole Kentucky Fried Chicken 57 recipe deal. So
yeah, no, it was very confusing. But their show was pretty good rate. Cumulus, they got let go and they didn't sign a deal. But it was just kind of a local thing. But I was trying to read the freaking ratings book. I'm like, this is so confusing.
Where did you have access to the ratings book?
Well, you go online.
Oh,
I mean, you go
that's
online.
Just that's not the real ratings book.
Well, of course, but I mean, whatever. It's the public ratings deal. Right. I mean,
so anyway,
you know,
listen.
Whatever.
Good luck with that chick. I would never say a bad word about pay per view, but man, that is an upgrade. Whoa.
Reed Zaresi. But that's another thing is then I start dating a girl with 1.4 million followers and a TikTok.
And now you're a bitch.
And that's what I'm saying.
She has 2 million followers.
Just like Hogan used to say to his entire family, there can only be one star in the family, brother.
Mm-hmm. And that's Primetime 99.
Back when they were doing Hogan's Knows Best and they all wanted to do split off and do their own little deals and stuff, Hogan had a family meeting and said, don't forget who brought you to the dance. You guys are all riding on my coattails, buddy. So
and that's a fact.
So
that's
at that point, man, you're her bitch, you know, socially. But then again, you get the rub. You get the rub off of her deal. Next thing you know, there you go, buddy. Get the rub.
Or if I put a baby in her, she's already got...
Oh, yeah.
She
get her
just
knocked
take care
up.
Of the baby.
Get her knocked up. Now you got an 18-year tether to her. Absolutely.
And she's like, she's about 5'10", and she's about... Yeah. She's a
trying to get
athlete.
Her pregnant.
Can you imagine our babies? It would be... it'd be... We got offensive tackle for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, guaranteed if I want him. I can get him.
We
got to
get
him right now.
We got to get going because we're way late. But, man, my advice to you is get her pregnant, buddy.
Great advice.
All right,
I'm
working on it.
I got some stuff working. I'll talk to you private later today, okay?
All right, hit me up.
Bye.
Peace.
Here's the self-proclaimed master marketer of the decade.
You hook up with me, boom, all of a sudden you got people wanting you.
The Bubba the Love Sponge Show returns after these words.